Hey, everybody, welcome into the show. Let's talk about Watson's for a few hours. This show, in a word, is going to be huge. Now, I understand that all the stuff, as we like to say, has gone hot. So for those of you who have followed the updates I've posted in the last 90 minutes on Facebook, just start calling, get over to the website, and start grabbing those. There are so many bargains in today's show, I couldn't begin to post video about all of them. So there's still a ton of stuff you guys have not seen. Let's check out a few of them now. As we get into this, you should know that we're going to do a speed show, which means roughly a dozen watches an hour instead of like 5 to 6. So you're going to see a ton of stuff. Now this one, here's one I did not get to post, but it's actually coming out as our spotlight. Look at this markdown. We usually get 237. It's 159.22 and 5 interest-free payments. Now that is a beautiful exhibition back mechanical automatic double retrograde. Now we'll talk more about details later on. It's large. It's obviously dramatic. It's a gorgeous dress watch, and it is priced to move. You know, I talk a lot about Stuhrling dials, for example, and that's such a beautiful illustration as to why I'm a fan. Now, this one's a big, aggressive sport look. Has that woven look across the dial, 3 different colors, really big, aggressive crown protector, as you can obviously see in this particular shot. Jubilee price of $182.64, 5 interest-free payments under V90692. Now, this next one is one that I was able to post. This is a huge deal. You're gonna pick your choice of dial color, which is a phenomenal guilloche design, by the way, in a big 47 millimeter case. 47 millimeter, by the way, is a massive size when you get into the squares and the rectangles. This, with the interchangeable straps, is only $109.78, plus we are going to do 4 interest-free payments. That is, to say the least, a huge deal. So please check that out in advance. There will be a significant wait in the phone room by the time we get to that. That watch is gorgeous. And I'm going to say that a lot, frankly, because there's a lot going on. All right, let's just jump into our first item. We're going to get Larry Magen, of course, from Stuhrling out here, and we're going to unveil the Alpine. Check this out. Now, one of the first things I want to tell you guys is that we're going to show you 2 different item numbers. The first of the two is V91541. Think of that as the black finish, if you will. And then you're choosing between the red or the blue. Now, it doesn't matter which one of the two that you choose. You'll see the other in a second. You're going to get the new size, the 52 millimeter size. Now, a lot of you already know the Alpine is kind of legendary for that big dome crystal. That hasn't changed. These are skeletonized mechanical automatics. That's been done before, but this dial configuration is new and the size is new. And a 10482, this is going to blow out of here in a major way. All right, so that's the first of the two. Here's the other one. It is blue or black, but you'll notice, obviously, in this case, it has that raw 316L steel color. So basically, you're choosing between the finish of the steel. Do you want it in more of the natural color? In this case, V91456. And if you want it in the IP black, it is V91541. But either of them will give you the skeletonization, mechanical automatic, the new size, the new dial. Speaking of new, right over here, Larry Magen.
Hey,
great
Coach.
To be in here, man.
Nice to see you, Tim.
Thanks. Likewise.
Welcome this afternoon, everybody. I'm so excited about the Alpine Slalom because, as Tim just pointed out, the Alpine is a legendary piece of ours, a skeletonized mechanical automatic, and this is the new version for 2010, the Slalom, which is the really big 52 millimeter. It just looks awesome on the wrist, Tim. I can't wait to put the black and red on here to show you what I'm talking about. Look at this, Tim.
Well, all the colors are going to be huge. And by the way, for those of you who have been asking about, because I get this fairly often, because people want to know about the strap size, the bracelet size, and so on, this is going to fit medium to very large wrist. I would say 7.5 or to almost infinity, not going to be an issue. This is very significant. For example, I wear about an 8, and as you can see, there's a huge amount of room left over as far as I'm concerned. And then you just tuck this away with some of the all these little, almost called a protector, that's incorrect. But they've got
keepers.
These little brackets, thank you, that they will use to tighten up or to tidy up, if you will, the strap. So that's how you're going to work this. Now, This is one of these things, I almost like to think of it as a hybrid, because in one case, it does play like a strap. It's very soft, very supple. On the other hand, it is actually made out of steel because it's this really cool mesh. So you've got that as a big plus. Why? Because it's going to last and last and last and last and last, and frankly, it's going to outlast any of the exotics. It'll even outlast poly. I mean, it's just gorgeous. Now, this is so loaded with new features. It's kind of like, where do you start? We've got the mesh. Yeah. I think one of the big new features is the 52-millimeter case, the new dial configuration. The perlage that you guys are now using on some of the base plates of the movement.
Mm-hmm.
This is staggering at $104.82. No wonder it is referred to as today's top value. By the way, the difference between this one and what we'll call the regular, for lack of a better word, today's top value, when we bring in usually a today's top value, we bring in a colossal quantity. Why? Because the price is going to be hugely aggressive. We know that the demand is going to be there. All right, this one, not so much. I mean, yes, the price is right. The demand is, well, look at the lines are already jammed. I mean, clearly, this is going to be a big deal. The issue is we don't have the huge depth of quantity that you guys are used to seeing on a lot of the TTVs. So just to kind of keep that in mind. Again, there are two different item numbers. We're going to keep coming back to that because we are showing two at exactly the same time here. One of them is in the black, and that's what's out here, and the other is the, I guess we call it the white finish. In fact, I'll bring one of those into the shot. In fact, yeah, this is perfect. So I'm wearing the black, and it's finished in the blue, so I'll show you the exact same blue finish, but with the white. And again, what you're going to see right away is that the size is identical and so on and so forth. The price is the same, the perlage is the same, the new size is the same, mechanical automatic skeleton is the same. You just see, do you want the black or the white? Now again, 541, if memory serves, it's going to be giving you the black, and then the 91456 is going to be the steel color. So we'll bounce kind of back and forth. Let me get that, in fact, the black out of the shot there for a moment to illustrate. So do you have a favorite, or is this still too new?
Well,
for
they're
you?
All they're all fantastic. The one that's on the screen right now is a favorite of mine. Everybody knows I do like the. You know, anytime you have silver tone with blue, I have a lot of watches that fit into that category. But the black is just so hot, and this electric red that I have here, it's hard to choose,
that
really.
That red is gorgeous.
But here's the thing. You know our Alpine. This is a freshened-up design for 2010, that propeller-style faceplate that has become so identifiable over the last 3 or 4 years, Tim. And now what we've done with the kind of triple design here with that propeller style. We freshened it up for 2010. It's a new design. As you can see right through it. Instead of the Arabics at 12, 4, and 8, you actually have Roman numerals here at 12, 4, and 8. Of course, I'm holding the watch on an angle, so your 12 o'clock is kind of over there on the right-hand side of the screen. But nevertheless, it's completely freshened up design. However, you still have some of the same feature characteristics like the cigar style hands, which are just loaded with superluminova. You still have that scalloped edge design on the case. You still have that, what we call that chakram style bezel, that big bulbous style crown, the big domed crystal. There's your case back, as you can see, exhibition. And we do have the ST 90089 movement, which is the higher level grade three-hand skeletonized in our catalog. So you're getting our finest three-hand skeletonized right here. There's your Stuhrling original signature on the skeletonized rotor as well. It's a screwed-in case back. So you have all of those same signature characteristics, but it has a freshened-up design. And instead of that guilloche that kind of is on the outer portion of the dial on the original Alpine, again, what we've got here now is these electric colors going around what's remaining of the dial around the perimeter. And, like, for example, this red, Tim. Look at this red.
The red is really, really cool. I want to give everybody a quantity update here as we get into this. Right now, the white, the one that's currently on the screen, that is V91456, especially in the blue, is outselling everything else. So at this point, top men are predicting that the 91456 in the blue finish is probably going to be the first to sell out. I think it's arguable that most, if not all, of this is going to sell out. But that one at this point. Now, again, obviously somebody could buy, a huge block, for example, of the black finish on the white, and that will change. But right now, that's what we're talking about. You know, one of the cool features, one of many on this, I got to tell you, when you take your accent colors and you look at what you do as far as taking it beyond just the bezel, like, for example, the that rubber accent that you guys use on the crown, you accent that in the color. The rotors are color coordinated.
Yes.
This was not haphazard. It's not just thrown together. There's obviously a lot of design here.
Well, Tim, I'm glad you brought that up. I know that you're very, very familiar with our with our roots and our history. You go back to our brand even before I joined the brand. I've been there almost 6 years. You go back about 8 years with Stuhrling. So one of the characteristics with the brand is we do a lot of that color coordination all throughout the dial, the strap, the case backs. That's very important to the detail. You were pointing out that rubber ring on the crown. We call that an equatorial rubber ring because it's like an equator going around the globular. Yeah, exactly. And it's color coordinated to the execution of the timepiece here. So you're absolutely right. And if you show the, for example, on the silver, there you go. On this one here on the case back, there's your color coordinated rotor that you were talking about. And something about blue and black. I think black, blue, blue, black is definitely, I think, one of the hottest color combinations of the last, let's say, 12 months, maybe 18 months. We've been seeing a lot of that, not just with Stuhrling Original, but with other watch brands as well. And we're kind of on that bandwagon now. We're doing a lot of blue-black executions. For example, tonight, the midnight blue-black tourbillon is just stunning. But here it is on the Alpine Slalom. I mean, it's hard to pick one, Tim.
You know, to sound like a stereotypical for a second, I mean, at this kind of money, if you can't make up your mind, pick up your top two favorites and so on. This is, by the way, to be clear, restricted, as are all of today's top values. In other words, I'm going to pick one here. Let's say this blue and the white. Let's say that sells out. That offer's off the table. At midnight Eastern time tonight, whether or not any of these are left, today's top value price, off the table. So this is the time to take advantage of your favorite designs. You've got the new larger case, the color-coordinated rotor. Prolage I mentioned earlier, that's referring to those little round circles you see over and over and over that are actually engraved by hand, incidentally, because I've seen it at the factories. That's on the base plate of the movement. So if you're a fan of decoration, this is the watch for you. You want the elegance and the prestige of mechanical automatic.
Yep.
This delivers. And, of course, that whole that big dome crystal concept. I still have my original Stuhrling from quite a few years ago. It's one I still go to. I wear it all the time. Now you guys update it in the 52-millimeter size. You add the steel mesh. There's every reason on the planet why we're seeing every line going. People love this.
Final word, Tim. The presence on the wrist, this new 52. Take a look at the presence here. It's just awesome.
Guys, I got to put a last call with inside of 15 seconds. Now, next hour, time allotting, we're going to visit this. And keep in mind, we're going to do roughly 12 watches an hour for you guys. So this is not going to be where you're going to see 8 minutes on this, 12 minutes on whatever. We're going to like bam, 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 right down the road. You're going to see a huge variety. And this one already generating a very, very significant response, and deservedly so. This is the spotlight. Check out the discount. The Jubilee price is $159.22. The usual price is $237.25. That's a big case, 316L steel, your choice of layered with gold or not. And of course, that double retrograde, which is referring to those two fan shapes, the exposed escapement. Very, very high-end look for a very small amount of money. This one, double rotor, it's not an automatic. This is the double rotor big date at the top. Quartz accuracy. We have so few of these that we're predicting that we may not even show it live. So I'll just tell you, if memory serves, I think it's a 44. It's either 42 or 44 millimeter case.
44.
Layered in the rose gold. The guilloche design on this, which I think is one of you guys' fortes.
Absolutely.
Is phenomenal. Now, again, everybody at home, we may not show this live. Order it based on this shot or go for additional shots over to ShopNBC.com. You should be going over there anyway because we got every line going, and I'll just get you around the waiting phone with that route. All right, let's go ahead and get into another one of the major highlights. So this is one that has certainly been out on websites. I had it out on Facebook within the last couple of days. We've seen a hugely positive, I guess we could call it, review/anticipation. It's a brand new watch. We're going to show this in three different configurations. So maybe we should start by getting into that. This is in no particular order. Green, red, and yellow. I'll give those to you again. Green, red, and yellow. This is a very big watch, estimated at 49 millimeter. Mm-hmm. You're going to notice the steel mesh, again, used in the bracelet. The advantage of steel mesh, by the way, and I guess this is kind of the way I break it down, the mesh is very soft and supple. So if you like, as I do, for example, strap models, you're going to love this. But it has all of the strength that you associate with the steel.
Oh.
This also adds the cost rather dramatically to the watch. And this one, in fact, lists for over $1,000. Now, you add to that things like special, I almost want to use the word, I guess, coatings as far as the coloration is concerned, mm-hmm. a Swiss Ronda 5030D engine, and so on and so forth, you begin to understand why that ramps up so dramatically. Now, check out the Jubilee price. It's going to be $198.24. with three interest-free payments. Now, what is ValuePay? ValuePay is a series of interest-free payments that allows you to take our product, in this case, it would be the Iconoclast, pay it out over a few months. ShopNBC does not charge you any interest to do that. So let's check this thing out. We're talking about a Cristerna crystal, which is a very durable, very scratch-resistant material. Fantastically detailed dial with multiple colors, multiple layers, handset markers, luminous hands. We're talking about a solid back that's engraved and also handset. What does that mean? It means that an actual technician built this and finished this by hand. Check the water resistance. This is not something, and we mentioned this in the first, and I'm sure we're going to do this in a lot of your products. There's nothing haphazard about the way you guys design the watches,
absolutely,
the way the watches are executed.
Well, you're absolutely right, Tim. There's nothing haphazard. This is engineered from scratch, from pencil on paper. This one, the Iconoclast, is from our Apocalypse series in our Epiphany collection. And this one is the first time we've actually tinkered with the bezel design. It doesn't have that decagonal bezel design, but what we did with the bezel, it still has the signature case of the Apocalypse, but what we did is something, one of the most expensive bezel designs we've ever done. You have a base aluminum bezel that has a Duracoche finish, and then the steel bezel on top has die cut minute markers. You see the 10, 20, 30. Those are actually cut out of the steel. Very expensive. A nice feat in engineering, but the Duracoche finish showing through. This is probably going to be your most mainstream execution that I'm showing you here. They're calling it the red, as you can see right here. I'm just kind of, this will probably accommodate, I would say, up to about a 9-inch wrist. I wear an 8, and I easily have about an inch of play in here. It's a very thick 4.5 millimeter thick interwoven link bracelet. This is kind of like a jewelry style bracelet. And if any of you out there bought our expensive Tourbillon, the Revelation, with the big 52 millimeter case, this is the same interwoven link bracelet that we used on our Revelation Tourbillon. So that tells you what we think about this. And by the way, this is a 40, I want to say 48, if I'm not mistaken. Does your card tell you the diameter on this one?
It says 49, but you know, I'm going to throw a caliper on it.
That's 48 or 49.
10 o'clock, 4 o'clock, 49.23.
Okay, 49 really millimeters, exact. So it's got a really large presence on the wrist. And by the way, we haven't mentioned the mechanics of this piece, but this is the Ronda StarTech 5030D Swiss Ronda quartz chronograph movement. So it does have add and split functionality. It has 6 jewels. It's completely repairable. It does have a 12-hour totalizer counter down there at the 6 o'clock position. And look at the color-coordinated carbon fiber dial. Now, I'll grant you, this is kind of a wild execution, green and red, Tim. But if you like that kind of color combination, I mean, that's wild, Tim.
But I think that part of the point of this watch is to be wild, to have a degree of control, but at the same time, let's go with a bit more outlandish color. Let's
bring, absolutely,
as you point out, red carbon fiber, case in point, instead of the usual black. We're combining this with an electric green, an electric yellow, more of the electric red to the outside. By the way, to update everybody on quantity, you know, quickly, this is selling. There's fewer than 100 right now, and I don't mean per color. I mean everything.
Wow.
This is almost gone. In fact, now there's fewer than 80. This is going to be out of here, and it should be.
You know, you mentioned about the point of it being outlandish. You know what an Iconoclast is? It's a rebel.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what this is. This is a rebellious timepiece because we switched up the bezel and the color executions speak to that.
This piece, if you want something that is, well, an Iconoclast, and you want a price to move, there you go. And there's well inside of 80 now available, and it's just hit the screen. I mean, this is going to be gone. Let me give you guys a few more highlights. This is another one that I didn't get a chance to post out on Facebook, but nonetheless, it's going to be a big deal. In fact, you guys already discovered it via the website. Blue is gone. We still have some left in the black, some of it left in the silver. This is a big, heavy, rectangular case presented on a multiple-link 316L steel bracelet. But to cut to the chase, this is why this is selling out on its own. It's under $100. It's $99 and change, and that's before you get to interest-free payments. The bracelet can run you that. This is the kind of values we're going to be showing you throughout this afternoon and this evening,
absolutely,
for that matter.
Sir.
So let's just get to this next one. This is huge. Okay, let me begin this one by, if I may, showing you guys a few of the different colors here. This is, in no particular order, blue, silver tone, rose tone. Blue, silver tone, rose tone. These are bigger cases, as we talked about in a preview, 45 millimeter. There's a lot as far as the story is concerned here. I think that one of the biggest stories, other than the fact that this is a mechanical automatic, and within that, adding, for example, the retrograde features and so on, is the extreme dial detail. That combined with the exceptional discount. Now, let me start with some real basics here as we continue to take you on a tour of the watch. For example, what is a mechanical automatic? Well, when you talk about the history of timepieces in very general terms, prior to the advent of quartz technology, which allowed us all to put batteries in the watches, you either had, for the most part, you had a mechanical, and relatively recently they developed the automatic version. And the difference is that an automatic will have this rotor, which is that kind of a crescent guy there, and he's bouncing around as you walk throughout the day and so on, and that winds the mainspring of the watch. You can certainly also wind it here with a crown. In this case, it's more of the pumpkin-style crown. The point is that these are entirely built by hand, whereas quartz, which has the battery, those are largely built by a machine. It's a computer building a computer is what it comes down to. These are built out of hundreds of custom parts entirely by hand. So now we're talking about buying the artistry of hand-making wristwatches. It therefore has the elegance and the prestige. And this is the same concept, by the way, that is literally applied to watches that go for series 4 figures, 5 figures, 6 figures, and so on, the vast majority being built by hand one at a time. Now, you combine that with an extreme discount, and then you get to dial detail. Now, one of the things, and I've certainly written about this in the past, I talk about it on the show all the time, Larry, is the fortes that different brands have. And I think one of the keys that you guys consistently bring to the table is extreme detail in dial design, and I would hold this watch up as a prime example thereof.
Without a doubt, we are so proud of our Saturnalia, Tim. This goes back about 2 years now. It has become a signature piece for our entire boardroom collection. It certainly is a boardroom style piece. I think one of the things that goes to the grace of the piece, besides the nice dial work that we do have, as you talked about, but is the double mill, double step design bezel that gives it an intricacy that gives you that grace and elegance. But to have a 33 jewel mechanical automatic with a retrograde day of the week complication over there at the 2 o'clock position and a retrograde day of the week at the 10 o'clock position, all off of a single mainspring, is phenomenal. And then take a look at the Jubilee pricing, Tim.
Well, you're talking about $159.22, and I'm going to come back a little bit. Let's talk about the retrogrades.
Sure.
Retrogrades, I'm very used to seeing on watches for 4 figures, 5 figures, 6 figures apiece.
Yeah.
And frankly, for years, that's where, if you wanted that feature, that's where the money had to be. And the advantage that Stuhrling has brought to the table, in my view, probably, well, since 1999, really, but especially in the more recent years, when you guys started getting serious in retrogrades, is that you guys are using engines that allow them to become really affordable. Now, what is a retrograde? Well, let's talk about that. We're referring to the two crescent shapes, or fan shapes, if you will. One of them, as you'll see here, is numbered 1 through 31. That's obviously the day of the month, or date of the month, I should say. And what happens simply is when this is going to move all the way up, it hits the 31. Post 31, it literally snaps back, and we'll start over here at the 1. The same thing here, in this case, pointing to Sunday. Now, when Sunday concludes, that will drop back down to Monday and then move through and so on and so forth. It's a very regal, very elegant approach, in my estimation, to taking what are known as complications, which is a fancy way of saying it's a trick that a watch can do other than tell time. And it really lends this elegance to the dial. You guys step up and move even further, for example, adding the custom-built crescents, the frames, the half halos that go around it. This is a very, very sharp-looking watch. And, well, you can take a look, for example, as Larry's going to be wearing one of these in just a second. This is one of these pieces on, and I say this often about Stuhrling, is when somebody wears this, nobody is ever going to look at this, be it in a boardroom or a restaurant, especially, you know, we're wearing suits today, and you look at this and go, it's about $150. And there's no way.
That's right.
This looks like you spent so much more, which I think is another forte that you guys do.
Well, I mean, that's, you're talking really about, you're speaking to our mission as a brand, really. We're all about respect for the art and tradition of the Swiss watchmaking legend, and we're, you know, bringing it at affordable prices through valuable partners like ShopNBC. But here's the rose tone. This is 16 karat rose gold layering on the stainless steel case. And, you know, one of the things we didn't really speak to is the open heart complication down there at the 12, 6 o'clock position, where you have a reveal in the dial with the balance wheel beating in the background at 21,600. And one of the things I do love about this particular timepiece is the bow tie bridge. Every time we do a reveal, we're always looking for different bridge stylings. This we call a bow tie bridge. And it even has that kind of flywheel that's synced to the second complication that gives you that faux tourbillon effect, Tim.
Well, let's take a look at this up close, because speaking of tourbillons, you guys are going to be doing one. I think it's tonight, I think, at 9 p.m. Eastern, I think.
9 p.m. Eastern, that's correct.
Might be at 8 p.m. Eastern, now that I think about it. Yeah, it's 8 p.m. Eastern. By the way, if you want to see some video of a real tourbillon, I posted that on Facebook yesterday, and it's still out there. Tim Temple on Facebook, and there's all sorts of updates about today's show and the tourbillon for tonight, and you can actually see it in action. Now, tourbillon, I can't even get into right now what it is, but suffice to say, it's a very expensive, really cool complication. And it looks like this. Now, this isn't a tourbillon, but back to the point, it really looks like one initially in operation. So this is giving you, as you rightly point out, Larry, this is the look of the tourbillon. Here's that bow tie bridge that Larry was referring to. And so you have the look of a tourbillon with a double retrograde, but you're not spending huge amounts of money. I want to go over the three different colors here, because I was going to announce fewer than 100. We're already down to fewer than 50 left here of the blue. This one is the blue. Name for the blue you'll see, of course, on the raised Arabic numbers, also on the skeletonized hands. All right, this is blue. The one between us is under the word silver tone, and frankly, it's going to be near identical to this one, except it has more of a charcoal approach to the numbers and the hands, and you'll see it balanced here between the two of us on the set.
I refer to this one as our tuxedo execution, Tim.
Well, that makes total black sense, obviously, with the charcoals and the whites and the blacks and so on. So if you want the most, sophisticated, it even has that outer track done in the charcoal, this is the one under the word silver tone. Very regal and elegant. Let me scoop some of that reflection off so you guys can see it. Just gorgeous. Now, if you like to go with the high-end look in a case, and you want to look, of course, at gold, specifically rose gold. And Larry, that's the one that you're wearing.
You know, it's not often that I go for the earth tones, but today with my new earth tone colored suit here, I went for the rose tone with the brown.
Yeah, which plays phenomenal. It's gorgeous. The warmth, the natural warmth and the elegance of the rose gold, it just ties in beautifully. And more of that charcoal around the exterior, and you even accent one of the retrogrades with it, and rose, more of the rose gold used on the other. Just gorgeous, gorgeous stuff. All right, I've got to put a basic last call out on this. All you need is a single item number, V90299. Both of them are 45 millimeter, I should say all three. All three have the exhibition backs, and they all have, by the way, the much larger and heavier than usual rotor, which is from a very specific factory that does this, and it's just gorgeous. All right, now, let's take a, we were just referring to this one, actually, so let's check it out. Again, I don't want to encourage everybody, you can see this one live. If you want to see specifically the blue one in closer detail, go to my page on Facebook, Tim Temple on Facebook, and shoot me a friend request, and you're going to be able to see, to my knowledge, it's the only video to date of this actually in action up close. Now, the blue one is going to be debuting tonight. I believe it is at 8 p.m. Eastern, 7 Central. You should know that all the tourbillons that have ever been brought in by Stuhrling have sold out invariably within just a few minutes. I think tonight is going to be no exception at all. So please note the time, 8 p.m. Eastern, 7 Central, and so on across the United States. And you can check that out. That's going to be a huge debut for you guys. Now, Larry and I are going to be continuing with Stuhrling, actually, for a couple of hours for you guys beyond this one. And then we'll move into 6 p.m. Eastern, and we'll get into the Sense of Weight Loss System, followed by 7 p.m. Eastern, The Perfect Sleep with Serta. So a big variety and a big lineup for you guys today. And following that, of course, is the Watch Time with Jim. And then you're coming back for that with the tourbillon and a whole lot of other stuff. All right. You can't say I didn't warn you. This is one I did get to post on Facebook. And by the way, one of the reasons you guys want to sign up for my page on Facebook is I do what's called ShopNBC Backstage Updates. Now, I, for example, did not know until I arrived today that this watch, A, was in the show, B, that it was going to be marked down to $85. So I shot some quick video, I posted it, and the reason we're already seeing a huge, huge chunk of these gone is that, frankly, several thousand people had the opportunity to see this video in advance and learn that this is going to be a special event, a special price, and so on. Not to mention, it's a really beautiful, we could call it a comeback or what you will, that you guys are now looking at one of the great classics in your history. Mm-hmm. This piece, if memory serves, I think it's a 40-millimeter case.
That's right.
It is the steel bracelet, all in 316L steel. What does that mean? It means surgical-grade steel. Again, there's going to be three different choices here. This is no particular order as far as quantity. Silver tone, rose tone, and black. This is silver tone. which is the one vertical right there. Next to it is going to be black. What's the difference? Well, they both have the charcoal black dial, but the one under black is going to, as you'll see here, is going to have the additional IP plating, which delivers the black color onto the bezel. And you're also going to see a really cool charcoal, kind of a gunmetal, really, influence in the color that's out through the center of the bracelet. Now, the third one is under the, what do they call that one, rose tone, and that's over here in front of Larry. Has the same charcoal on the dial, but you notice the layering of the rose gold on the bezel through the center link, which is some really nice knurling that's done on it. All of these are exhibition back. All of these have color coordinated rotors in the mechanical automatic engine. For example, the rose has rose layering, as you'll see. The black has the black. In fact, I'll spin one of these around and illustrate it. The bottom line here, Larry, since it is Jubilee and we're talking today particularly because of very aggressive pricing, this is a mechanical automatic on a bracelet model, not strap, which means it costs more, in 316L steel for $85.96 and with interest-free payments.
Amazing.
This is going to sell out. How can it not? In fact, we're already inside of 90 seconds.
Yeah, it is amazing, Tim. Now, this is our original Sea Lion. Now, this is the Sea Lion 2, where this design goes back about 5 years now, but it's still a staple in our water sports collection from our Sea Lion series. This is the original 40-millimeter case design, and I think it's so important in our collection because, yes, we have been going larger and doing 50s and 52s and what have you, but believe me, I get plenty of emails, and I hear you out there. We hear you out there. A lot of guys say, don't forget about us. We still like our 40s and 42s. And there are some people that, you know, still prefer that because it was good 20 years ago and it'll be still solid 20 years from now.
You bet it will.
A standard diver style look on this piece. It does have a screw down crown. It is 100 meters water resistant. And here it is, you know, on the wrist to give you a view of what the presence on the wrist looks like, Tim.
And guys, I got about 30 seconds left, and we're already inside of 50 now of each one of these. And this is how quickly this stuff blows out of here. Again, not to overly belabor this, but if you'll join me on Facebook, I'm telling you guys, it's a great way to learn about the highlights of any given show well in advance that I'm working with. Now there's fewer than 40 of any of these available. Again, the colors are rose tone at the top, black in the lower left, silver is the name to the lower right. That is a mechanical automatic exhibition back for under $90. It's $85.96 and with interest-free payments. Very, very cool. All right. The extra today's top value already blowing out of here, and as well it should. There are two item numbers. If you want it finished in the black with the red or the blue as options, it's 91541. 91541. If you would like it finished in the silver, which is actually more the raw 316L steel color, if you will, your options obviously in the blue or the black as far as the accents. It is the 91456, both available at just $104.82 with four interest-free payments. You guys can check it out for $26.20 in the shipping. That offer will be retracted at midnight Eastern or sellout. And it looks like at least at this point, the silver with the blue is going to sell out. And I think probably at least three of the four are going to. We'll do that live for you guys next hour, but let's move on and get to our next watch. As we promised you at the top of the show, and this will continue throughout, we are going to do roughly a dozen watches an hour, which is far faster than we usually move. Why? Because we've got a lot of great stuff that Stuhrling's brought in to celebrate the Jubilee and special pricing and so on. So let's get into this one. All right, three choices here. We have black on black, silver tone and black, and silver tone and brown. Now, if I had to guess right now, I think silver tone and brown is going to be the big story, but we'll see. The brown one, by the way, it's not rose gold. It's not like a misnamed product. This is what I would think of as a very rich, kind of an opulent, if you think of like the antique as an antiquity bronze. If you've ever seen some of the antique, the literal 2,000-year-old pieces they discovered that are bronze. It's that kind of a concept. You guys, again, back to the color, back to dial detail, back to the utilization of what in the industry they call fancy case design.
Right.
But people no longer have to spend thousands of dollars to get some of these features. And it's a wonderful thing.
Absolutely, Tim. You know, I think the Expedition was one of the first, maybe in the first three models we ever did brown PVD, and it gave us this rich bronze tone. And that was a couple of years ago, and we've been doing the bronze tones, you know, ever since. And I don't think anybody does the bronze tone as well as we do. We're very proud of our bronze tones, and this is right in there. Now, this particular movement in the Expedition, you know, I'm going to take exception with you. You think the silver tone brown is going to be?
I think
the silver tone black, which is the one that I own, can go with everything. But this is a great sport timepiece. It's from our Safari series in our Sportsman's Collection, and it looks fabulous on you, Tim. And, you know, this case design where you have the covered, you know, the bridge with the covered crown is inspired by a very high-end Italian company, actually. And, of course, many watch companies out there are certainly taking their whack at that particular look. We've got a few models in our line now that we do that with. But this particular movement is the Citizen Miyota OS 25. It's got the 10th of a second indication down there at 6 o'clock. But once again, you can use your bottom pusher to put it in chronograph mode or set it to simple time mode where it becomes the second hand for the watch. Just like we showed you on the earlier timepiece.
I'm glad you brought that up, because that's a feature that I don't think every consumer or collector is aware of, is that so many people historically, when they see that larger hand moving around, they naturally assume that that's the second hand of the watch. It's not necessarily true. In fact, it almost never is if you're talking about a chronograph watch. But I think that you have the option to actually convert that over is a really clever concept.
Right. Now, right now, I just, and by the way, you'll notice how the chronograph second hand is not lining up, and we actually have an instructional video how to calibrate Citizen movements. It's very simple. If you want me to demonstrate, I'm more than happy to do it. You'll open this up. What you're going to do here is you're going to pull the crown out, and then once you have it pulled out, you're going to just use your pusher here to calibrate it, and right there, and now it's recalibrated already. It was that simple, and now I've got it 12 o'clock straight up, and if I start my chronograph, there it goes, chronograph mode. There's your 10th of a second indication at the bottom. I can stop it, and then I can reset it, and it resets right to 12 o'clock. And then I can put the mode back to simple time, and now this becomes your second hand for the watch. But it's a great movement. It's a great timepiece. And, Tim, you'll notice it has that tinted acrylic plate for the subdials at 6 o'clock and 9 o'clock, which is a nice touch as well. But just a fantastic sport piece. And, you know, we actually featured this piece in Watches International in 2008.
Mm-hmm. Well, let's talk about this dial as we're taking some of these sweeping shots. One of the things that obviously I talk about at great length in Stuhrling is your attention to detail on the dial. And when we're looking at this, case in point, all of the custom work, if you look, for example, on this watch at the, I guess, from roughly the 6 o'clock to around the 9 o'clock position, there's a single custom executed piece of metal. It's actually, once it's been milled, is then set by hand. And you'll see it here. Here's a live shot where I happen to be wearing the one that's available under the word silver tone and the brown. I mean, that obviously isn't an accident. You guys plan this,
yes,
you execute it
absolutely.
First in computers, then you go to the computerized lathes, and then ultimately back to hand building, where all of these three-dimensional dials are built by hand. 45-millimeter cases, case back is machine set on this particular instance, which means it is actually torqued in with a claw, which gives you the great water resistance of 100 meters, which is a little bit unusual, by the way, in dress watches, believe it or not. A lot of those don't really go that high, and this one does. As you already talked about, the signed crown protectors on each 45-millimeter case presented on rubber straps. Just a very hot, very in vogue look, and another great choice from you guys, no doubt.
Well, thanks, Tim. We're very proud of our expedition. It is a signature piece for us. Oh, the iconoclast. How are we doing there, Tim?
Okay, this just debuted. A lot of you are I'm sure, keenly aware of that. It is now being officially called by Top Men Limited. Which basically means we are estimating it is likely to sell out in the immediate future. Jubilee priced at $198.24. That's a very big watch that you're looking at. And, of course, the addition of that wonderful mesh bracelet, which, as you rightly point out, is actually literally created like a piece of jewelry. It's a much higher-end route now that's being taken to create the mesh. And gorgeous colors on that. It's aggressive. This one, to say it's popular is an understatement. In fact, again, we're going to be calling this one at least one of the colors sold out in the immediate future. Usually we get $237.25. Jubilee price is $159.22. These are big cases. If memory serves, I think it's roughly 45.
It's a 45.
Yeah. 316L steel, double retrograde with the exposed escapement, gives you the look of the tourbillon. All at $159.22. Gorgeous, gorgeous dress watch. There is much still ahead, including some of the stuff that I was highlighting earlier. The ladies' skeletonized diamond watch is going to be coming out here. Just really, just, man, tonight, I'm so glad to be a part of the show. This is just great stuff. And speaking of which, the Zephyr. I really like this design. I do think to an extent this design is polarizing, but I prefer that. I think it was really great, like this and the Metropolis, as you know, yeah. I'm a huge fan of. Uh-huh. And I think you take that approach to design, which is deliberately outlandish. It is basically celebrating how outlandish that somebody can be in case design, in dial design, and let's tell the time, but let's do it in a bit of a different way. And that's, I guess that's one of the reasons I'm such a huge fan of products like the Zephyr. This one is Jubilee priced at $166.72.
Wow.
And here again, we're going to be talking about a couple of different options here. There's red and white and red and black. Now, as you see them in a fairly wide shot, it becomes more apparent as why they're called that. This one is obviously the black. This one is obviously going to be the white. A very intense red. I mean, there's not a whole lot of subtlety going on mm-hmm. here, but I think isn't that really kind of the point of the whole watch, whether it's how it tells time, whether it's how it shows the date, how it highlights, if you look at the 6 o'clock position, how it mm-hmm. highlights the day of the week, and
right.
among, I think there's two features built into that.
Yep.
The second hand
yep.
is actually done with a disc. I mean, this is to me, it's innovative, it's fun, it doesn't look like anything else on the planet, which is one of the ways that I approach my personal watch collection, is to get, you know, is it unique, is it something that is going to be different and fun to wear? All of this has been combined into this production. Now, I have to assume that you have seen a very positive response overall to this product.
Here's the thing about it, Tim, the Zephyr. Now, positive response, I would say yes. I think it's more of a collector's style of piece. It's a very large tonneau shape case. Not for everybody. It's very thick. It's probably 16 to 17 millimeters thick on the wrist. But, Tim, this particular design has roots that go back about, with our company, Stuhrling Original, about 4 years. And you may not be aware of it, Tim, but I will tell you this right now. The first time we ventured into this style of case design was actually inspired by a gentleman by the name of Tim Temple, because Tim, you were one of the first people that we when we were working with you in the past, you know, this is inspired by a super, super high-end Swiss brand that you're a huge fan of, and you had said do something along those lines, and this is the third model now that has been inspired by that high-end brand that you brought to our attention and said you have to do something like this. Now, I don't know if you remember those days, but that's where it got its roots. But in any case, what is so awesome about this piece is, yes, the design is spectacular, but the movement itself, Tim, a 22 jewel mechanical automatic with retrograde date coming off of the same center axis as your hours and minutes. And then on the sub-dial at 6 o'clock, you have your second indication on the same canon pinion as the day of the week.
Mm-hmm.
That is fantastic. That is unbelievable in watchmaking, and then therefore we packaged it in just a tremendous design.
Well, I know we've just got scant seconds remaining here, but just look how this is set up. It's got the pointer date, which actually works in a retrograde that sweeps across the top half of the dial,
mm-hmm.
Inside of a little magnification lens.
Mm-hmm.
This is where you're going to be getting your day of the week. Below that is a rotating disc that, of course, is the second hand. And I also like how you split up the hour hand. I
mean, it's a double-sided hour hand.
Just,
yeah, Tim.
Uh-huh. This is coolness. It's what it is. $166.72. It is an original thought, and I really try to celebrate original thought in watches, because so many watch companies out there look at somebody else that's got a hit, and we'll do our homage to that. And to actually do something that's fresh and original is mm-hmm. brilliant. So good for you guys. All right, let's take a look at something coming up tomorrow. This is a 36-inch strand ranging from 10 to 12 millimeter fresh water cultured pearls. We have sold almost 3,000 of these, by the way. And the intro price is coming back, which means you're going to save over $15 additional from the ShopNBC price. Plus, we're going to give you 4 interest-free payments. And you guys can check that out at 2 p.m. Eastern Time right here, ShopNBC. Excellent buy. Don't miss it. Now, as I've been mentioning, of course, Larry and I are going to do several hours for you this afternoon. We're in the first of 3, as a matter of fact. A little bit later on tonight, 6 p.m. Eastern, Sense a Weight Loss System returns. And following 7 p.m. Eastern time, Perfect Sleep with Serta. So a great variety. Before we come back with Watch Time with Jim, which is going to be tonight, which gives mm-hmm. you guys to bring out the tourbillon and mm-hmm. a lot of cool stuff there. All right, the Tuskegee 11478. This, despite what the, you look at that price and you go, well, they have to have come out with a quartz example. No, actually, this is a mechanical automatic example. And it's available in two different colors. So once again, I want to start with that. It's black and red. Black and red are the two different ones. And it's so named because you've got obviously, well, we can't say obviously, but you'll see in a second here. You've got black across one of the dials as far as the pigment that was used to create the numbers and the markers. And this one is red. Now that stated, I would personally call that more of a brick red. So don't think of it like a racing red or fire engine red or something like that. It's not. But I've often thought of this series. And you may have a different tact on this, but I really think of this as a wonderful homage to some of the great, like the pilot's watches, for example, 1950s in particular comes to mind. And then you guys bring in things that really elegant coin edge, adding in this instance a five-link bracelet where the original would have been on leather. I mean, this is just one of these things that is loaded, it's packed with value on a great-looking watch.
Well, Tim, this is from our Bravo Zulu series in our Sportsman's Collection. We call it the Tuskegee Elite. Because what we did with our original Tuskegee design is we tweaked it a little bit. We put it on a solid stainless steel link bracelet. As you can see, we added the coin edge. We gave it the skeletonized hands. So we kind of, you know, dressed it up the Tuskegee. I believe this is a 40 millimeter diameter, maybe 41. If you want to check on that for me, you might have the information on your card. But you're right about the fact we're calling it red here. To me, it's more of a root beer color or possibly a cinnamon color on those numerals and markers there. But this one is both of the executions, regardless of which one you get, either the black or the what I'm calling root beer, they're calling red, they have the all luminous dials. Now earlier today with Sean, we were selling our new Tuskegee Bomber with the all luminous dial, and we almost sold it out last night at 3 a.m. That had was the only execution with all lume. On both of our executions of the Tuskegee Elite, and there are no other executions, only these two, they have the all luminous dial on the bracelet, Tim. Did you get the diameter? Was it 40?
42.
It's 42.
42 and change.
Thank you, Tim.
42.
Thank you for checking that for me.
No problem.
So it's a 42 millimeter case design. I'm going to pop one on the wrist here. So either way you go, the black or the root beer, I'm telling you, this is a fantastic Jubilee offering right here, Tim.
And then you add the fact that you're including the 316 L steel bracelet at this kind of money. Now, first of all, bracelets cost, frankly, much more than a lot of people realize until you've actually gone out and shopped for them.
You're not kidding.
And when you're talking about owning a Jubilee price of in this instance, you know, 114, 115, frankly, if somebody had just told me you're going to do an automatic Tuskegee, because I'm basically familiar with the series, I would have leapt to the conclusion, knowing the price point, it's going to be a strap, which is still an amazing deal and a great homage and so on. The fact that you guys are including what a lot of collectors and consumers consider the upgrade, moving from the strap into the steel bracelet, and yet allowing a Jubilee price of $114.70, I think that is, frankly, a huge deal. I'm glad you brought up the luminous dial. I think one of the major calling cards of this series is, when we talk about luminous, and so often, you know, whoever's doing the show will refer to luminous markers or hands or whatever, because that's what's going on. The fact that the entire dial is luminous, again, I have to assume that you've had a big positive
Without a doubt, the Tuskegee series or the Tuskegee line in our Bravo Sula series is really one of the hottest things we have going now. We've done about four or five, and this particular Tuskegee Elite, this was actually came out about 3 years ago. This is not something that just came out last week. This is all new production goods, and it's all new stock, but it is one of our hottest series that we have going. And one of the things I said last night about the Tuskegee Bomber, I love the plume style, the choice of the plume style hour and minute hands. This is the only model that I can think of that I've ever seen in our gallery, and anywhere, where I've seen skeletonized plume style hour and minute hands. It gives it such a touch of, you know, from a sport watch to let's take it into the boardroom almost, really. It's just tremendous.
Well, doesn't it also therefore speak to the talent that you guys have as a design team, where you're saying the basis of this is going to be a pilot's watch, specifically in my estimation, more the 1950s design. However, is there a way that we can approach this so that in the 21st century, a lady or a gentleman, and I think given that it's a 42, both can easily wear this. So you're talking about, can they bring this into the boardroom? Can they wear this with a suit? Is it just the weekend watch where you put on with jeans? And I think what's interesting is that you've been able to achieve, I think, both of the looks. This is one that absolutely, in my estimation, somebody wants the mechanical automatic, you like the nod to the pilot's watch. With your added touches on the dial, you can bring this in with a suit. And at the same time, you want something casual on the weekends, it's perfect for that.
Absolutely, Tim. You know, like I say, You can wind it by the crown. There's so much you can do with a particular design. If we have a hot design, then we're going to go to rubber straps, leather straps, steel bracelets. We're going to go to chronographs. We're going to do as much as we can. And, you know, one thing we're trying to stay true to, though, on the Tuskegee is do them always in automatics on the Tuskegee, because the inspiration is from the 40s.
Sure. That makes total sense. Last call on this, guys, be 90308 to take advantage of it as we go ahead and move on to at least more watch, one more watch here in this particular one. All right, on the screen currently, that one is extremely limited. Basically, we're down about 20 of each. Now, for those of you who missed the presentation earlier, that really is $85.96, not a payment, the whole watch, and it is a mechanical automatic exhibition back watch, 40 millimeter case. You choose from the rose tone or the black, which is in the lower left, or the silver tone, which is in the lower right. Luminous markers, luminous hands, and a terrific opportunity to own something that Stuhrling had a massive success with, what, about 5-6 years or so ago?
Oh, absolutely.
This one. All but gone. And in all candor, we don't think we're going to be airing this live. This is a 44 millimeter case, heavily layered in rose gold. The big story here, in my view, is the beautiful guilloche design in the dial, which is referring to that engraved look on the dial, combined with a double rotor big date at the top. 119.18. The vast majority of that already gone. We will not be doing it live. You can learn more about it on ShopNBC.com. Now, this is one I did get the post earlier on Facebook, and I'm glad to see so many of you have already taken advantage of it. There are three different color choices, so as we get into this, one of the things that you'll need to choose from, of course, is the black or the silver tone.
Right.
Misspoke there. It's black or silver tone, guys, two choices. 47 millimeters, I talked about on Facebook, and which, by the way, is an unusually large square case. It is large if it's a round case. It becomes very large when you build that size in a square or a rectangle. In this case, the square. Now, this is an exhibition back mechanical automatic, so the first thing you're going to choose is, do you want the silver tone or the black? Now, moving beyond that, part of what works, I think, magnificently here is, whether you want it or not, you're going to get a total of three different straps included, which means if you want to go a bit louder, a bit more outlandish, you throw on, for example, the red strap. Kind of in between the blue, a little bit more of a classic, maybe even a sport design in my estimation. Also pulls, for example, that black beautifully off the case and certainly off of the dial. You throw the black strap on.
Right.
This is something that can be done without any tools at all because you guys used a quick change system. Mm-hmm. In fact, let me grab one of these and we'll just walk you guys at home through this very quickly and you'll see why I was excited to show this early on and why a lot of collectors have already stepped up and grabbed theirs. It is the larger case. You'll notice it does have the curved back. That means it's going to be more comfortable. It's also a nice testament, by the way, as to the quality of the original production. You've got a semi-skeletonized dial, which illustrates some of the mechanics of the movement. You'll also see the phenomenal guilloche design, which is referring to that engraved design. Now, the Aussie, as a lot of you guys know, is kind of known for the... is definitely known for that multiple coloration of all the numerals that's sweeping around, so no exception here. So, guys, when it comes down to, you choose either the silver tone, which is the silver-colored case, obviously in steel, with the silver dial, or the tone-on-tone with the black, which really makes those colors pop. So, it's kind of like, what's your poison? I mean, what do you like? Do you like the skeletonization? Do you like the guilloche dial? Do you like the oversized look? Do you like the interchangeable straps? You guys have combined all of this and more and delivered this at an amazing price. I mean, I really want one of these. This is a fantastic deal.
Tim, I'm wearing my own personal one here. Now, I will tell you this. When we first came out with this a few weeks ago as a special offer here on ShopNBC, you know, I was a little concerned, to be honest with you, because for 3 years now, I've been wearing the original 41 by 41 millimeter, okay? Mm-hmm. I'm hooked on this one now. This is 47 by 47 millimeters. Look at the presence on the wrist. It is just stunning. And now when I go back to my original, I got to tell you, I've trained my eyes now for this bigger version of it. I love it. And of course, I have the black as well. But, you know, here I wore my silver tone to Minneapolis this weekend. I wore it on a plane. I've been wearing it every day. I just love it. And the comfort hasn't changed. We still have that really nice curvature of the case. It's got a curved case back, curved case, and curved crystal as well, which is more expensive to do. It is a mechanical automatic. This is just a tremendous value. And the way that it's going to come, it's going to come on the black rubber strap. Whether you order the silver tone or the black, it comes on the black strap. Now, I see that, you know, here in the visuals, they've kind of rearranged them a little bit to give you an idea of how the different looks that you can create. But it is going to come on the black strap. Now, here's the black in the box, the way it comes. And you'll see, you know, over here, you have the two extra straps that are put into the insert there. And there's your black one on the pillow. It's just stunning. And no one will ever guess what you paid for it. You're going to be blown away by the quality of this piece. And you'll be blown away by the comfort, Tim.
Well, which comes, of course, back to the fact you guys have brought over what I think is a lot of the highlights from, if you want to call it the original that you did, including the curved back. Now, why have a curved back? Well, I can give you two key reasons. The main one for collectors and consumers is that, as a rule, a watch that has a curved back is going to be more comfortable to wear than a watch that does not. So, obviously, from a comfort standpoint to the consumer and collector, that's a big deal. From a manufacturing standpoint, there's kind of a show-off factor because, frankly, building a curved case costs more. There's more technology involved, and that's why, frankly, some watch companies just don't mess with it. But Stuhrling does. Now, you add to that the additional cost of this being, for example, a mechanical automatic. You could have done this in quartz. By the way, I would still love this design at this money if it was done in quartz. But the
right.
fact that you guys are doing the skeletonized mechanical automatic, and then you're also adding, in fact, maybe we could show some close-up shots of this dial. One of the things that I think is just so perfect that you guys continued on this is not just the multiple colors in the dial, it's the fantastic guilloche design. Now, I want to talk a little bit about guilloche because I've mentioned it several times this hour. I haven't really defined it. Now, when you use the term guilloche, actually what you're talking about is a hand-carved dial, and usually they cost huge amounts of money. Breguet, for example, is a great watch for phenomenal engraved dials, among others that are out there, certainly. But the guilloche design is actually done with a multi-ton press, and then it's actually finished up by hand. But the end result is that you have the concept of a very, very high-end engraved dial, but you don't have to spend the money to get it. And of all the guys that I see mess around with these dials, I think you guys, first of all, are doing among the most pristine as far as the detailing, and you're certainly making it among the most affordable to the consumer and the collector. Mm-hmm. And when you add it to a case like this, that is the mechanical automatic, it is the larger size, you've got three interchangeable straps, this becomes, I think it's an irresistible deal on so many levels, and it's a little wonder that you're seeing the huge response that you are right now.
Oh, definitely so, and I'm sure that we will do more with this case. Now that we have gone and invested to make the tooling and the design of the mm-hmm. larger case design, I'm sure we'll do something like maybe a big chronograph or something. You know, on our original Manchester Aussie, we did do a Manchester chronograph as well, but in the same case. But this is the first one in the larger case design. And I would just say this to anybody out there who may have passed on it last time a couple of weeks ago because you thought, that's just too big for me. Let me just throw this out there. Don't be afraid because I've gotten used to it. We've gotten a lot of emails in response from people saying, you know what, I was a little nervous, but it works on even smaller wrists, Tim.
Guys, we've got to take a quick timeout, so we'll be placing, obviously, a last call on this. It's available at Vias and Victor 91500. You simply choose in between the silver or the black. Now, next hour, we're bringing out today's top value extra. This is, yes, the Alpine. Some of you will recognize it, but you won't recognize the new 52-millimeter size and the new dial design, among others. You can get it in a black finish, and it'll be 91541, choice of black or red, or blue or red, I should say, or the white finish, the 91456, and this is available with the accents in either the black or the blue. Notice just 104.82, so it's really quite remarkable. Anyway, we got to take a timeout, so let's do that, and we're going to come back with a whole lot more in a couple of minutes.
ShopNBC is celebrating National Better Sleep Month, an entire month dedicated to you sleeping soundly. Stay tuned all month to find mattresses, mattress toppers, bedding ensembles, sheet sets, and more. Make sure to watch Tuesdays at 4 a.m., 11 a.m., 7 p.m. Eastern Time for Better Sleep Month specials. It's Better Sleep Month on ShopNBC. A good night's sleep doesn't get any better than this.
Things are getting better. Things are getting better. Oh, oh, oh.
We're stepping up our style during Fashion Week at ShopNBC. With more fashion premieres ever in 1 week. They're the names that are changing the game. ShopNBC is your destination for fun, fresh, and fabulous fashions. Travel to the exotic lands of Asia with Far East Market Jewelry, where purity and perfection meet elegance and affluence. It's time to discover the treasures that may only be found in the distant markets of the East. Stunning, precious, beautiful, and always beloved. Join us for Far East Market Jewelry here on ShopNBC. Discover the shoe that breathes. It's Geox Footwear. Combining Italian ingenuity, design, and fashion, you'll discover wearable and versatile shoes featuring a patented breathable design. Now you can relax, walk, or work out in comfort with Geox Footwear. Premiering on ShopNBC during Fashion Week.
Hey everybody, welcome back into ShopNBC. My name is Tim. Let's get underway as the Jubilee celebrating Stuhrling is continuing. We've got 2 hours for you guys where every single watch is going to have a special Jubilee price. Now, another thing you're going to see different today is that instead of doing, say, 5 or 6 watches an hour, we're going to be doing the better part of a dozen watches an hour. And this is one that I did get to post earlier out on Facebook, so a big chunk of these obviously gone. This is a oversized rectangle, gorgeous mechanical automatic. You're choosing the silver tone of the brown, if memory serves, on this. It's only $124.82, and it is stunning in person. If you want a big oversized dress watch, it's going to be one of the best buys of the whole day. It's the simplest way to say it. Now, this one is coming out in 4 different colors, as you can see. I think the red and the yellow are probably going to be the two big stories here, but you can get it in blue or black as well. $127.18 for a beautiful chronograph with a woven dial, the 91388, for those of you who wish to take advantage in advance, which, given the huge demand so far, I got to tell you, is really a good way to go, whether you want to call or get on the website, shopnbc.com. Now, this one's the Florio. This is one that's presented on a rubber strap. The rubber straps, by the way, have really come into vogue in ultra-high-end watches. 5-figure, 6-figure watches are doing it fairly regularly now. So you check this out, layered in the rose gold. It is a beautiful mechanical automatic, and you can check it out for just $114.23, along with some interest-free payments to go, make it even more affordable. Notice, and you can see it in particular in the rose dial, the guilloche design or the texture design on the dial, it's a spiral, and then that spiral actually sweeps out physically onto the bezel where it's sculpted into the steel. So it's really pretty cool. Speaking of which, let's check out the brand new Alpine Slalom right after this. Well, I guess the first thing we should tell you is that we had a very, very big response last hour, and I do not anticipate it's going to be any less this hour. Secondly, you should know there are 2 item numbers because we're going to show you this in a black finish and a white finish. Black currently on the screen under V91541, so black obviously, and then you choose between the blue or the red accents. The color accents, by the way, are carried over onto the rotors, which we'll talk about in a bit. This is the white, and this is V91456, and you're choosing between the blue or the black. Now, a lot of you will recognize, of course, the Alpine, but what you won't necessarily recognize, because this is very, very new, is, for example, the new case. This is a much bigger case. It's a 52 millimeter, significantly larger than it's been in the past. You've also got a new dial design. Now, the propeller concept, which has been a constant, is held over, but with a new approach. This is Larry Magen. He helps make this stuff.
stuff. Thanks for being here, man.
Okay, Coach. Listen,
so, huge. Last hour, you blow up the phone lines with this thing. I think we'll see the same this hour as well.
Well, absolutely. And if you didn't pick up the Alpine Slalom yet on this opportunity here, you're going to love this piece. It's a mechanical automatic, but it's the size, Tim. It's all about the impression on the wrist. And everything we're doing this year in 2010, the designs are getting a little bit more brash, mm-hmm. a little bit more bold, a little bit more aggressive. And we've carried it into one of our all-time pieces here with the Alpine Slalom.
Well, I'm going to grab one of them here. In fact, I'm just going to trot off of this red one for a second, and then we'll show you guys in a little bit greater detail. Exhibition back mechanical automatic, as I talked about a little bit earlier, the bigger case, the 52 millimeter. We're talking about a very heavy crystal. This is done in Cristerna or in the mineral?
I believe it's the Cristerna.
Now, Cristerna, for those of you who don't know, is a material that's actually taken from the eyeglass industry, and therefore it's got magnificent optical properties, but at the same time, it's very resistant to scratches. It's a product you can actually basically bang around, and I'm not encouraging you to like unnecessarily knock your watches around, but the point is it's a very durable material, and that is what is used to create that very large bubble or dome concept you see across the top of this. Now, as we get into the design of the dial, you'll see at least a couple of levels there. Great metallic finish as far as the color is concerned. The perlage, which is those little circular decorative, circles that are across the base plate of the movement. That's all placed there by hand, by the way. I've actually watched them do that in the factory, and they use what looks like a handheld drill. And it's got a diamond bit on the end, and they just create their circles over and over and over. So there's a real hands-on artistry to building not the just the case, but even the things like the plates and so on in the engine are all done by hand. Notice the color-coordinated rotor that is across the back, skeleton movement, of course. For those of you not familiar with the term skeleton, it refers to the fact that it is, skeletonized. You can basically see through the movement and so on. So, Larry, you add all of this stuff up, and then you guys blow up the case. It's up to a 52 millimeter. You guys are bringing the color accents now out onto the bezel, onto the, and it's a great name I learned from you last hour, the equatorial line that you guys have added mm-hmm. to your globe shape that's making up, obviously, the crown. I think this is a sharp watch, but more importantly, we're seeing hundreds and hundreds of people across the United States agreeing with us. They think you've got a huge hit here, and so do I. Mm-hmm.
Well, you know, we love our Alpine. We're doing more and more with it. We've got a ladies' Alpine slalom coming up, I think, either this hour or next hour, Tim. It's a ladies' version of this. But here it is now in the 52 as a today's top value extra. It's a fantastic opportunity to make a bold statement. Now, I'm wearing it here with a suit. And you could pull it together with the suit if you want to, but to me, this is from our Lifestyles collection, our mm-hmm. Alpine series. It's more about the casual lifestyle, the sport lifestyle. This is just a fantastic everyday watch for if you're talking about a mechanical automatic every day mm-hmm. as opposed to a quartz every day. But, I mean, this is something you're going to turn heads with this, Tim, because you can see it from across the street. I mean, this is a large statement piece at 52 millimeters. And I remember when we came out with our original Alpine in the same kind of case design, but it was 44.
Yeah.
You know, we thought it was so huge about 3 to 4 years, 4 years ago now.
Sure.
Okay. But now this just dwarfs it. And I'll tell you, it's a great statement piece, but we kept the same signature characteristics that made the Alpine so lovable, really. You know, the domed crystal, the scalloped edges on the case. Everything about it is just a little bit blown out. Look at these black executions here, too. We never did black executions like this on the original Alpine. The bezel design, the big bulbous crown, and I love the new skeletonized, freshened up propeller mm-hmm. faceplate that we did on this. It's a new design on the faceplate. The 12, 4, and 8 are done with Roman numerals, and they're done, you know, so subtly that you almost don't even realize, oh, yeah, that's a Roman numeral 12 up there. It just kind of blends into the design, and look at that, what's remaining of the dial with that metallic red. That is just shocking. And listen, if there's any new people out there that are unfamiliar with what is a mechanical automatic, remember this, there's no battery in this watch. Ladies and gentlemen, if you're new to watches, you're new to watchmaking, you don't have a battery and a computer chip. It's running off of a spring, really, a bunch of gears and pieces of metal and screws and things like this that are just put together in such a way that it keeps near perfect time. And one of the things about owning a mechanical automatic, and particularly a skeletonized mechanical automatic, is that you're showing off your appreciation and affection for watchmaking, and you're sharing it with others because it's all out there for everybody to see, and it's done with such a beautiful design in our Alpine series, Tim.
Well, let's go over the color choices here in perhaps a little bit greater detail live, because I want to make sure everybody's getting, obviously, the one that you want. Keep in mind, there are going to be two different item numbers here. For example, 91541, that's going to be in the black, which is the ion-plated black finish. Something you might find interesting, by the way, is that when you're talking about the black color, it actually costs more to do this than it does creating the gold. And you might not think that. Frankly, I didn't know that until I actually visited a factory that is doing this kind of work. But this actually costs more to do than even the rose gold. So anyway, this is the black. Now, I happen to be holding the red and the black. And why don't I just go ahead and grab the blue, and I'll just set it down one right next to the other. So this is the basic difference, obviously, is that this is going to have the blue and the black accents. And this one, you guys actually kind of reversed that out.
Right.
And so the screws, for example, are done in this really cool, just a touch of red sweeping around the bezel. I think you guys nailed this as far as bringing it.
It's hard to pick.
But isn't that a great point, though, when you talk about the balance of the color? For example, you guys even thought this out. Let's not bring the red bezel. Let's flip that. We'll do the screws only in the color on the red and then the blue. Now, the number one seller so far, to move on to the colors that Larry has in front of him at the moment, is the blue in this. Now, it's a different item number. It's V91456. Now, as far as the new dial, that's the same. Exhibition back, the color coordination with the rotor for the engine, that's all identical. And in the blue in this so far has been the number one seller. Now, I know we're coming down inside of a minute here, so I want to remind everybody that because this is under the Today's Top Value umbrella, there is a key rule that applies here, and that this offer is going to be withdrawn at midnight Eastern time. No matter how many of these sell, no matter how much in demand it is, if you call after that or you go to the website, I'm not saying necessarily the, well, you know what, on this one, I think the offer is actually off the table entirely, but if it's not, it's going to revert to $150. So either way, this is the time to place the order during the debut when you've got the guarantee of the Today's Top Value price and you still have all four of the selections. I have to think, Larry, when you guys had this there in your New York headquarters, you saw the finished production, you had to know this thing was going to blow up like it is.
Well, you know, listen, all these designs, everybody's giving us a lot of compliments on the new designs that are coming out for 2010. I'm just as blown away as everybody else is. When these new designs come in, Tim, we're just digging it.
You guys did nail that one. I mean, there is no doubt at all. You guys did such a great job on it. All right, coming up a bit later on, the Esprit. Now, this one is going to be marked down, as you can see, to $198.27. You've got a couple of color choices. A lot of you, of course, favor the bracelet examples versus the strap examples. This is a heavy power look in a bracelet and the multiple level dial. We'll talk about the complexity you see there just a little bit later on. You guys are going to be able to pick this up at just $198.27 and some interest-free payments as well. Now, this, I don't know if it's going to really pop in this shot or not. It may not. But here's what's really, at least I think is cool about it. It has this, I want to call it, if you think of a sky blue, but it's more of an electric hue to it. That's what's concentrated against the stark black background. I can remember the last time I attended the Basel Watch Fair that this was one of the huge trends in very, very expensive sport watches. The big four-figure, the mid-level, literally $30,000, $40,000, $50,000 per watch. One of the big stories is this lighter, not an electric blue, it's a sky blue with kind of an electric overtone against the black. And you guys, I think, did a fantastic job bringing that to the affordability table, and we'll talk about that a bit later on. All right, now, we were just talking about this a few seconds ago in regards to complex dial design. This shot, as nice as it is, really is not, in my estimation, going to illustrate the physical depth, and by that I mean the three-dimensionality that you guys were able to achieve in creating dials. So, all right, here's the shot that does, though. Check this out. Now, you've got a watch here that's a big watch. It's a 49-millimeter, 316L steel construction, Cristerna crystal. We're talking about, I believe, 100 meters water resistance, so a very durable watch without a doubt. But I think the design is a big part of the story. Deep dish dial. Notice that each marker, the Arabic numbers, very three-dimensional. They're actually sculptures that are a part of the outer track of the dial. Now, if you look inside of this dial, look at the halos, which is the term to describe the pieces that, in this instance, are actually created separately, and they frame the subdials, if you will. So you look at this one, that's more of a flat dial. This, however, has definitely got a kind of a delta or the angled approach to it. And then you look at this guy.
That's a bridge.
This is beautiful work.
Yeah, and the can opinion in the center has to be extremely tall so that the hours, minutes, and second hands can clear that bridge of the retrograde day of the week. This is the Citizen Miyota JR00 movement. But I want to point out something really quickly here. This is a limited edition. We don't have a lot of pieces here, Tim. There's only, I think, 150 in one and maybe 150 in the other, 125, and we sold most of them. So it's very, very limited. This is like a little hidden jewel on Sunday afternoon on Mother's Day with Tim Temple right here, fellas. If you're watching the show right now, even this Jubilee price, I believe, if I'm not mistaken, you guys can correct me in the control room if I'm wrong, I believe this is actually lower than when we sold it last summer in the limited edition special show. So this is a hidden jewel, but there's only a few pieces of each. We have some of the blue and some of the, they're numbered on the case back. You get a certificate of authenticity with it as well. And it's just really one of our finest, and it's a beautiful stainless steel link bracelet as well, Tim.
Well, I think one of the big stories here, and you did you more than alluded to it, is that a lot of times when Stuhrling builds watches, you build in a very significant quantity because it's one of the ways, of course, you're able to amortize
right.
out and bring the cost down and so on. I think one of the big parts of the story we're seeing today is that you built this one actually in a very minute quantity, which
yeah.
is, now, of course, on occasion you guys certainly do that. The Tourbillon is a great example of that. But to be able, in this kind of a price range, to offer something that is actually scarce, there's only a handful relatively available.
Right.
If somebody were to buy the entire production, they still only have a relative few. And then you look at the two different colors, whether it's, by the way, are blue and red. Now, I took you on a little tour there where I showed you the red. Larry currently wearing the blue. The blue is, frankly, a little bit more lighter in overall color temperature. You'll see, for example, some of the larger plates on the dial are done more in a brushed silver, which is more of the steel color, whereas the red one actually has much more of the black. Now, the plates, of course, are identical. You still get the brushing, and you get the herringbone and so on. But it's a great illustration as to how color temperatures can vary even across common surfaces when it's done properly and done cleverly. And you guys, I think, have done a wonderful job in this production. Solid back. You guys are carrying over some of the dial concept in the engraving on the back. This is fantastic work that is designed to look very high-end, but at the same time is brought in really, really affordable. Let me also, once we're on the back.
See the numbering on there, Tim?
Yeah.
Right above the Stuhrling and just below Gen X Pro, you see the numbering. This is number one.
One of 150. 135, 150.
So there aren't too many to go around. Each case is numbered. You do get a certificate.
So obviously very, very few of these.
Correct.
I'm going to come back and again show you guys this dial up close, and I know we got barely a minute here, and this is equally true of the blue or the red. I happen to have the red one here, but when you look at this, you still have luminous markers, luminous hands. For example, there's lume material located here, certainly on the hands, but when you look physically into the dial, I think, honestly, one of the big stories on this is not just the scarcity of the watch. They only made 150, and I assure you in a Stuhrling that's highly unusual, but you get the incredible three-dimensionality. In fact, I'll rotate. There you go. You see this even a little bit more. For example, this halo is flat. This one definitely built with an angle. This one has a very significant elevation. And inside of that, you've actually got, as you'll see here, it's more than a red-tipped hand. It actually will highlight each one of the prospective days. This, by the way, is a Greenwich Mean Time or a 24-hour dial. Above that, this is day... the week, I think, or the month.
Calendar.
That's the date of the month up there, I think.
Yeah,
that's the date of the month and day of the week down here. You guys have this knack for dials, and I talk about that a lot, of course, on a lot of your products because I think it's true. I think it's one of the key reasons to own Stuhrling, and this is a beautiful example is why I'm a fan of your dials. It is just gorgeous. By the way, I've been updated here. I don't even think there's 20 of these left per color. So you guys need to buy this. This is seriously almost sold out. All right, let's take a look at the spotlight, and it's going to be featured tomorrow in this particular instance. In fact, it'll be this time tomorrow, 4 p.m. Eastern time. And what we're talking about here is a drawstring bag. This particular one is built from lambskin, and we have sold more than 1,900 of this since it launched in February, and with Fashion Week kicking off tomorrow, by the way, here. You're going to save more than 10% off of the ShopNBC price. We're going to offer 4 interest-free payments. And again, that's going to be Monday, 4 p.m. Eastern, right here at ShopNBC. Thank you. So let's talk a little bit about our programming coming up throughout our day. Stuhrling is going to be continuing this hour and next. Following that, we're going to have at 6 p.m., these are Eastern times, by the way, 6 p.m. Eastern, the Sensa Weight Loss System, and at 7 p.m., The Perfect Sleep with Serta. And it is not on this, but I do want to mention it at 8 p.m., Watch Time with Jim, and you're coming back for that.
Mm-hmm.
And I think Michael Davis, also from Invicta, is going to be here. But the point is, you have the Torbia,
mm-hmm.
which is, needless to say, been a huge, huge story. It's been a huge story every time you guys have built
yeah.
one. And I believe I'm correct in saying you've never had one not sell out.
That's correct. That's
just
correct, Tim.
Phenomenal success for you guys. And that's going to be true tonight as well. I appreciate that you're very gracious about it, but that is going to be here and it's going to be gone. By the way, if you guys want to see some video of the Torbjörn, check out my page on Facebook, Tim Temple on Facebook, and there is about a 16, 17-second video where you can check it out. Okay, so let's talk about this. Now, there's a whole lot to refer to here, a heavy steel bracelet, I suppose, for starters. You guys are getting more into the fancy case design, even with the exhibition backs. We're talking about I guess we could call it semi-exhibition. You guys
mm-hmm.
are doing more of the crescent moon approach as far mm-hmm. as that is concerned. Much like the last piece, albeit on a different dial concept, I do once again think your dial design is a big, big part of the story here.
Sure.
So let's get into this. We're talking two different color choices here. I believe I'm reading this right, black and gray, I think, are going to be the two from which you can choose. Black is going to have the red accents, and that's the one that Larry is obviously showing you there. And I've got the one in gray. Personally, how I would break this down, I think, in this just opinion, I think the black is going to be a bit more sporty, though I do consider this a dress watch, and the gray is frankly a little bit along the lines of the dress concept. You'll see multiple levels of the gray, by the way, combined with some silvers and some whites, and you still get some nice red accents in there, so it's definitely eye-catching without a doubt.
That gray is awesome.
It is. It's really cool. It's a 21-jewel engine, by the way. It's a Citizen Miota, so you're talking about mm-hmm. a very accurate and a very durable mechanical automatic engine
yep.
that makes up this particular production. In fact, let me illustrate that by flipping this around.
Right.
And you can see across the back, and I think this is a nice touch.
Oh.
I've seen selective brands do it. You obviously are one of them, and that is, okay, we're creative on the top of the watch. We do creative dials. We do creative cases and bracelets and so on. There's no reason we can't become also more creative with the windows across the back of the watch, and you guys are illustrating that you can have a lot of fun with that.
Yeah, the semi-exhibition case back, we did it on the Arbelos, we did it on the Esprit, and once again here with the Esprit de Vie. Now, guys, everyone out there part of Stuhrling Nation, you know our product line. If you're one of those Stuhrling collectors out there, one of our real big fans, this is, again, a hidden jewel in this show this afternoon to pick up the Esprit de Vie on this Jubilee pricing offering here. This is a substantial piece, Tim. It's a 49-millimeter case design. It's right knocking on the door of 50. It's just a hair below 50, and it's got a huge presence. It's extremely significant in its weight. Don't know exactly the weight, but it's certainly, I'd say, north of 250 for sure,
mm-hmm.
of 250 grams. But this one will surprise you, guys. When you bring this home, you're just going to be blown away. The quality, the significance, the heft. You've got a Citizen Miota 8247 movement in this piece, 21-jewel mechanical automatic. And I'll tell you, it's the bracelet. This is one of the finer bracelets. This is really one of the first pieces we did where we really busted out to get into that 48, 49, 50 club. And this is the version not on the leather strap, but on the bracelet, the Esprit de Vie. And it's pretty heavy and thick as well, Tim. But this is a head turner.
Well, we talk about color accents, something else you guys really excel at. Let's look, for example, at the black, which you happen to be wearing at the moment.
Sure.
When someone selects the black, you're getting the charcoal black dial. You're getting more of the IP black treatment, or the ion plating, if you will, treatment, happens to be on the bezel. You guys even carry that color through the center of the bracelet as well. So if you are fans of the more contrasting watch, I think this is a little bit more sporty. That's just my opinion. And you take the black on the black, so you have the tone on tone, you drag that out through the bracelet, you really accent the red, which is a nice heavy metallic red, almost like a hot rod red you guys are using on the dial. I think that's a fantastic way to go, compared to the one that I have in front of me. Same architecture, obviously, same case, same dial concept, but now we'll do it a little bit more along the lines of a dress concept, where you've got the very elegant gray in the background, and then various silvers, a little touch of red added in there. You don't have the same concept with the black being pulled through the bracelet. In this case, it's done with a brushed 316L steel that moves through the center. Now, both of these are going to have the dual deployant clasp across the back. That's not going to change. They both obviously have the larger case, as Larry was describing it, with the 49mm Cristerna crystal. Cristerna, again, taken from the eyeglass industry, so the optical properties are wonderful, but I think besides that, one of the biggest deals is that it's also very scratch resistant, very durable. I think it's a very logical choice, especially for your designs and your innovations to bring in that added durability as well as the clarity. And this watch, I think, really sums it up. Now, the second hand on this, because some of you are saying it's a mechanical automatic, where's the second hand? Well, first of all, not all mechanicals have second hands, but most of them do. And you guys actually did this really cool three-dimensional sculpture here that is the letter S, as you guys can see, I assume for Stuhrling. But
that's right.
But at the same time, that whole sculpture continues to move constantly once the watch is wound, a great visual factor. And again, let's do a bit of a departure. Why does every second hand have to be this stick that just moves around on an axis when we can create sculptures that'll do it? Another reason why I love collecting Stuhrling personally.
Yeah, the designs. And like I said, this is, to me, one of the pieces where we started to really step out and get into the bolder designs.
Now, I think I'm going to have a chance to show this next one to you live one more time, but I think it'll be next hour. This is today's Top Value Extra. Now, among other things, it not only means a very, very aggressive price, but it means that offer does expire at midnight Eastern. It's already been a runaway hit, and for very good reason. Big watch, 52mm, huge dome crystal with new dial design, beautiful design in the skeletonized mechanical, color coordinated on the rotor, for example, in the mechanical automatic engine. The black finish is V91541, 91541. You can also get this without the black IP finish. You can get this, for example, in the silver, and you choose the accents there in the blue or the black. But all of the technical aspects are the same. It's only $104.82, and then, of course, the four interest-free payments to go along with that. All right. This next example, this is one that I, just across the board, in all candor, I urge you to buy this. You will become a fan of Stuhrling. Now, I can certainly say that among, for example, the most outrageous dials that you do, because that is kind of how I personally approach Stuhrling. You know, if you want four or five level dials that have weird discs and they fly around, and I mean that's your company. Okay, this is very much the opposite of that. This is regal. This is elegant. This is absolutely fantastic. I'm going to show you this in two colors. I have this in a brown currently on the screen, and I have this in a white. This is a big case, 47mm by 41. Now, that doesn't sound that large in a circle, but when you build squares and rectangles, numbers like that play very, very large, and that's exactly what's happened here. Right. Stuhrling color coordinated the sides of the case. For example, you see the chocolate brown here. This plays out into more like an antique bronze as they've created it's more even than just the sidewalls. The section of the case that moves through the lug area of the watch reflects that accent color as well. Hand-built dial, phenomenal guilloche design, hand-placed markers and numbers, but you'll see the elegance of the semi-skeletonization on the dial coordinated with the exhibition back. Again, all in the 316L steel. The bottom line is when this is Jubilee priced at $124.82.
Wow.
Exactly.
I just saw
this is my point. If you want to see why I'm a fan of Stuhrling, why I encourage thousands more of you than already are to become fans of Stuhrling, you don't want to go with the outlandish at first, which I totally get. It's not for everybody. Check this out.
And
you
Tim,
will be a fan.
And Tim, did you notice the integration of the strap? This leather strap is phenomenal. It's not an inexpensive strap by any means. It does have the steel platform inserts for the case integration at the lugs. Very expensive to do, Tim. You know, when you have a piece this significant in size, you don't want just a flimsy pin. It's like having a solid end link on a stainless steel link bracelet.
Okay, so show people at home not familiar, what are you referring to?
Well, what I'm referring to is this, and I'm actually going to take the watch off here. Okay, thanks, guys. Okay, let me push through. It's got a push-button dual-deployant clasp as well. But this, you'll notice the slope here. You'll notice the slope of the how the strap immediately follows the slope of the lugs. Well, right in here, okay, at the lugs, you can kind of see it from the back. You have a steel pre-curved metal insert sewn into the strap that the pin goes through, and it gives you perfect case integration with no gap to the case, so it's solid when you have a big case strapped to your wrist rather than just a pin where there's a gap. That would be an inexpensive way to do that, and you don't want to cheat it on a piece like this. This is our Metropole from our Metro collection, Tim, and it is spectacular, and you're right. This is one of the real values of the afternoon.
I think it's one of the steals of the whole show. In fact, I think it's one of the steals of your entire stay with us over the next several days. At this kind of money.
I was trying to switch with you, by the way.
Oh, try, sure.
Yeah, because, you know,
I have my new brown suit.
You know, I almost never do browns, guys.
All right, here we go.
I let the salesman sell.
Let's say hi to Lee in Connecticut. Lee, welcome. Thank you for holding. Welcome to the show.
How you doing, gentlemen?
Hey, Lee, how are you?
I'm doing fine. I enjoy your products, Larry. They're excellent.
Long time no speak, Lee. I recognize your voice.
Oh, that's nice. I had a question for you, Larry, just to start right off the bat. I have one of your Voyagers.
Okay.
Which is a totally unreal automatic. I've never had an automatic that has also an adjustable second time zone.
Yeah, now, I don't know which one you have. Is it the Voyager 2, or is it the new Voyager?
Voyager with the globe on it.
The gold on it?
No, it's the silver with a globe and a bracelet.
Okay, so that's the now Voyager.
Yes.
Yeah, model 285. It's spectacular. That's a pretty beefy piece, Lee.
I've never had an automatic that also has an adjustable time zone on it.
Yeah, it's got the 24 major time zones on that piece. That is a spectacular one, absolutely.
Right, and the question I had, which I might have figured out really, is when I turn the inner bezel, that's just to tell myself where I've set it at?
Oh, boy, without having the piece in front of me, what it is, it has a rotating flange that has the ring of the world cities on it, and every time you want to check the time around the world, you have to line up the time zone that you're in, and it'll be able to tell you the time around the world. If you like, send me an email. We do have instructions on our website as well.
Well, I think I figured it out with the adjustable, like I said, the adjustable second zone, it seems to work out.
Yeah, because that one does have a secondary time zone as well, a GMT hand. That's right.
But all of your products that I purchased from you, I have your Millenniums. I also have one of your, not the top value, but the one down from that with the mesh that you put out, I can't remember the range.
The Alpine Challenge.
Right. That is beautiful.
Well, thank you very much. If you like the Alpine Challenge, you'll love the Alpine Slalom.
Well, I wish it was in my budget to buy that many watches, but I love looking at them.
All right, Lee.
Thanks for the call, Lee. I appreciate
much
it.
Much love to you, Lee. Thank you very much.
Good question and good answer. And actually, I think we're wrapping this, are we? I think. Okay, yeah, we got to go. There's hardly any of these left. It's at this point, it looks like the white dial is going to go first. But it's either brown or white. That is, for dollar spent, I'm telling you, it is one of the strongest buys in the entire Stuhrling series of shows. Just amazing. This one, too, this is under $100. The blue one's already sold out. We have a few left in the black, a few left in the silver. Honestly, I don't even think we're going to be getting to that live. If we do, that would be great, but it looks like it's going to do just fine on its own. It's V90475, and it's to say the least, impressive when you see that. But in next hour, if we have a chance, we'll show it to you. Now, we brought this out last hour, and we certainly had a rather, shall we say, colossal response to it. And we're going to bring this back. This is, go to an overused word. This is a very cool watch. A lot of you will recognize the Aussie just in principle. They've done it in squares, they've done it in rectangles, and so on. And it means that you've got this real heavy guilloche design dial, which is meaning it looks like a very heavily engraved dial. And then you've also got, specific to the Aussie, you've got these really bright multicolored numbers. So in this instance, what we're going to be talking about is you're choosing between the silver tone or the black. Now, the silver tone is obviously going to give you, I'll take that one a little bit, going to give you a bit more of a bright silver case because it's the polished 316L steel. The black is also polished, but it's going to have the IP black color, the ion plating placed across the top of that, and it also celebrates, of course, the black dial. Now, these are 47 millimeter cases. What that means is that you've got a very big square. Now, I know in a circular case, that doesn't sound all that large in the current market. But a 47, when you're building a square, you're building a rectangle, those are actually really big numbers. So, yeah, this is going to play big. It's going to play oversized, which is obviously the point. Still very comfortable because it does have the curved back. It is an exhibition case back. I think the semi-skeletonized dial you guys brought out on this model makes a great deal of sense. What I didn't really expect, but it is a wonderful added feature, is this whole interchangeable thing that you guys are bringing to this concept now.
Yes, and you know, speaking to the interchangeable straps, you get a, no matter which color you order, whether it be the black or the silver, you will get, they're both going to come on a black rubber strap, but you will get a red and the blue option. The blue is what I call a cadet blue, okay? And so it does give you a few extra personalities, a few extra looks that you can dress it up with. But for me, it's all about the black rubber strap, Tim. I mean, that's just me personally. But I do want to say this. On these rubber straps, we went to great expense on the new mold to create these because you have a solid insert at the tip. So you have solid integration with the case. It's not just a flimsy rubber strap. You can actually feel, and that's why it is a little tricky when you go to change them because you don't have that much play. It's like a solid end link and you have to manipulate it into the lugs. And once you get it in, you've got that solid feel. And you need that when you have such a big, beefy case. You can't have a flimsy attachment. It must be solid integration if you're going to do it right. And there's no question we did it right, Tim.
Well, let's take a look at this in a little bit closer configuration. Case in point, as I already talked about, the bigger case. I mean, you look at this on. Again, 47 millimeter in current market, probably not that big in a circular case. In a square case, in a rectangular case, it plays very, very significant, as you can obviously see. Curved back. Now, curved back brings a couple of things immediately to the table. One of them, and I think the most important for consumers and collectors, if you're not familiar, is that it becomes more comfortable because a curve obviously fits ergonomically across the top of the wrist. But there is a show-off factor, I think, to manufacturing because, frankly, there's more of an engineering feat to build a curvature into a case, and then it can still house the mechanics that make up the movement. That's why most cases, quite frankly, aren't curved on the top or the bottom. It's cheaper just to make them flat. And you guys didn't take that route. You took the more expensive route, but the bottom line is that I think you built a better watch because of it. So take advantage of this, guys. It's V91500. You simply choose between the silver or the black. You get all three of the straps included in a very nice gift box, by the way. They did a fantastic job. Now, this was brought out actually last hour, and again, to much acclaim. I don't think I'm going to get to it this hour, but time allotting, we'll try to bring it out live, well, the few that remain, next hour. This particular time around, we're going to be talking about getting, first of all, the Jubilee price of $159.22, and you choosing between either the blue, which is the one with the all-white, actually, it's a silver dial with the blue accents, and then you can also get the one in the middle, which is the black or the rose tone to the left. Very regal, very elegant watch, 45-millimeter case, just gorgeous dress watch, without a doubt. Now, haven't shown you this live, and in all likelihood, I can't speak for the CBU, but it's available now. We're not going to show it this afternoon live, so you need to pick it up based on, frankly, a very limited quantity that we've got now. It's the green or the orange or the red presented on the polyurethane strap. This is another one of those great outlandish styles. I think that's one of Stuhrling's fortes, and it's a very illustrative of why I collect the Stuhrling. You're, by the way, I gotta say, Larry, you're one of the few brands that can actually do, and do very well, like a very elegant, like the Tourbillon, for example, tonight's a great example. It's very, very elegant, and it looks regal and wonderful. And then you'll turn around and you'll do something like the Metropolis or the Madman, and it's just this outlandish, fantastic thing. And both of them, you excel, and I just appreciate the versatility. You guys
thank
do
you,
such
Tim.
A great job.
No, thank you, Tim. You know, it's a challenge.
Let's talk about women's watches here for a bit. We've got several that we're going to highlight today, this being one. We've also, for those of you who missed it, I did post it on Facebook earlier. There is a skeletonized mechanical automatic with diamonds later on that you simply must have. This is very different. First of all, let's just talk price.
One of the reasons I didn't get this out on Facebook earlier is I just thought it would be fun to just talk about a watch for under $50. I can't remember the last time I did that, much less of a brand of the renown like Stuhrling has. There's four different colors, and I'll list these in no particular order. It's pink, white, brown, and green. Pink, white, brown, and green. Constructed in 316L steel or surgical-grade steel. You didn't give that up. We're talking about a 32-millimeter size. And this is another example where you guys have combined, which is insane, frankly, this kind of money, the stones on the dial using the more contemporary materials, like, for example, more of the rubber strap, the festive colors, things that so many of the consumers in current market want, and bringing it out at a Jubilee price, which is obviously designed to basically fill up every phone line we've got. This is a great product.
Well, thanks, Tim. You know, this is our Lady Clipper Sport, and many people out there may be familiar with our Lady Clipper, which is got a, you know, basically the same case design, but it's on a, you know, solid stainless steel link bracelet. And here, what we've done is we've given a sport version with the nice colors, you know, the kind of the springtime colors and what have you. To me, the white choice is the way to go here. I mean, they're all great, but that white you can wear every day, ladies. It's got a very high-grade silicone rubber strap. Feel how soft the rubber strap is, Tim. You'll see the flexibility of it. It's a 32-millimeter case design. It's got that kind of scalloped bezel design that we're all so familiar with. But this is just kind of like a classic dive style of case. So the ladies wear this pretty much everywhere, whether you're going, you know, to take the kids to school, or you're, you know, washing dishes, or you're going out to dinner. I mean, this, you'll get tremendous wearability and functionality, versatility out of this timepiece, but we put a Swiss movement in it as well. So it still has all the, you know, the hallmarks that make Stuhrling Original who we are, maintaining the same level of technical achievement for the ladies that we do for the men. For example, you do have a three-hand movement with a date as well. A lot of the ladies' fashion timepieces at this price point, you would not get three hands and a date. You'd get two hands, maybe three, but not a date. So you have all that. And speaking to your point about the price point, Tim, I don't remember ever selling a Stuhrling at this price.
I don't either.
Men's, women's, children, I don't care.
I want to go one step further because I've only got 30 seconds left. These are diamonds. This is a diamond dial for under $50. And that's before you get to the enamel on the bezel and the 316L steel and the color-coordinated rubber and everything else, da-da-da-da-da. White, we're inside of 20, so you know what? I'm going to call the white sold out because there's no way that's going to survive.
Admittedly, you know, small. I mean, you know, not like 2 carats of diamonds here, but there's a little bit of diamond accent, a little bit of glitter there, you know, just for...
But you guys could have gone with CZs or whatever. I mean, the fact that you guys are stepping up with actual diamonds at this kind of price, it's remarkable.
Look at the flexibility on these rubber straps. It's just tremendous. Oh, I guess we're done with that piece. Sorry, guys.
Now, this was on a little bit earlier. We were in a very limited quantity situation, and this shot, as nice as it is, just doesn't illustrate the three-dimensionality on that dial. And understandably, at this point, you kind of have to take my word on it. But there is incredible sculpting and three-dimensionality that goes on. And maybe in this close-up, you'll see a little bit more of it. I'm just such a fan of these more contemporary, very mechanical-looking 3D
dials. And certified limited edition as well, too.
Another good point.
Yeah.
Blue or the black is how you're selecting that one. And excellent choices all around. Okay, so this next one that we're going to be taking a look at, this is, where to begin? First of all, the woven dial, the fact that you're using a Citizen Miyota engine, so extreme durability, and it is not. That's what my information has. Okay. But we'll skip over that. Color-coordinated. We're talking, I believe, also about the Cristerna crystal, a beautiful homage to some of the, we talked about this last hour as well, the pilot-oriented watches and so on, which is a great homage to 1940s, 1950s. Though I also see, and I guess this is why watch collecting is interesting, sometimes it's really subjective, I see a nice influence from some of the 1960s when you looked at the watches that were coordinated with some of the racing watches that were really popular, especially in the early mid-1960s. You guys obviously have updated it. This is a much bigger case. It's a heavier example.
Yeah.
Some really nice contemporary colors here. And once again, add to that the chronograph feature. Yeah. There's a lot of major
concepts you've built in.
Absolutely, Tim. And I want to just make a slight correction here on the details that popped up there on the graphic for a second. It said 41. This is our brand new Concorso chronograph. I say brand new, I'm talking about for 2010. But this is the 2010 version. This is a 46 millimeter case. We stepped it up from the original Concorso chronograph that had a Citizen Miyota, like you were pointing out, that was a 44. But this is the new 2010 version that's 46 with the Ronda StarTech 5030D, okay? This is the new version, 5030D Ronda, Swiss Ronda, 6 jewels, add and split functionality. You're getting a world-class quartz chronograph movement in the larger case size. A very popular series, our Concorso series from our Sportsman's Collection. This is the 46 version, Tim.
So when you add everything up, one of the things that I need to come back to, I suppose, to break this down from a really basic level, is not just the physical, when you talk about the myriad of features that you guys mm-hmm. have built into this, and as you just rightly pointed out, some significant upgrades and some
yes.
updates with size and the movement selection and so
right.
on. But you guys have brought over what I think in this series, at least when I've been familiar with it historically, I think one of the big calling cards has been the woven dial, and you guys have carried that over. I think mm-hmm. it was a very smart thing to do. I think to have gone, for example, to a muted dial, this would not have the same excitement factor visually that this
yeah.
does.
Well, absolutely. You know, this series is extremely popular. We have 8 or 9 models in our Concorso series now. Last night we had our Monterey Bay out here. You and I may have it in our third hour, if I'm not sure, which is just a simple quartz movement, 3-hand, and it was at a price under $100, which was fantastic to get you started on this look. But this look is so popular, and it's such a high-end look, that when we decided to redo the chronograph version here, we went to a larger case size. We went to a more expensive movement. Now, we would not have done that in a series that was, let's say, not selling or not popular. Mm-hmm. To step up and go to the, we knew we already had a winner on our hands here. So you know the look, you know the design, and now you can get it with the Swiss Ronda 5030D, guys. So great, great everyday sports looking piece right here, Tim.
And you've also carried, as you did on the previous examples, that woven design concept, not only from the dial, but physically out through the cover
right.
of
the strap.
Of the strap. Thank you. And also maintain the color accents in the contrast stitching in the strap, further coordinating that back to the colors
yeah.
that were selected into the watch. Now, why do I point that out? Because it indicates the degree of detail that you guys insist on. For example, yeah. some of you at home, you go, well, so what? Well, here's the so what. If you wanted to do this, the cheaper way to go, the less expensive way to go, you pick a strap and you just throw that one strap on every example.
Yeah.
That way you don't have to pay artists to sit around and coordinate the Pantone colors from one to the next, and this one only goes in the red, or this one only goes in the brown, or whatever. Now, that's the less expensive way to do it. The correct way to do it, the way that expensive companies do it, is you color coordinate. Like, for example, the one I have here has white contrast. You're going to look at the one with the red. You're going to see red contrast, and so on and so forth.
Right.
And it's attention to detail, which is one
yeah.
of the reasons why I think you guys have the very significant following that you do.
You guys are going to love that piece.
Point that out. All right, so last call on this one being 91388, being the item number there, being 91216. What am I saying? It is 91388. My bad. Okay, so we're going to take a look at some additional examples here in just a very few moments. And first, let's talk about this is going to be, to say the least, a very, very significant opportunity. This is... how to describe this? Okay, it's you can see, obviously, it's mechanical and it's skeletonized, and another brilliant example of how Stuhrling absolutely celebrates the concept of skeletonization, both in the movement and in the dial, and also in the physical coordination with the colors on the dial versus the case versus the strap and so on. And for dollars spent, I think you guys arguably are doing one of the greatest jobs out there on that. Because you do, it's not just one or two watches. You guys are doing this over and over
yeah.
and over
We're
and over.
We're very excited about the Brumalia
yeah,
tonight.
You should be.
Very,
that's going to be huge. Yeah. So at 8 p.m. Eastern, I believe, to take advantage of that tonight. Okay. Moving on into, obviously, some other stuff. This one is V91216. Now, in this particular instance, we're talking about, again, the automatic example. This is going to be made available in this one single color, but it is quite the color. It's presented under black blue. It's just how you order it, but since it is just the one example, you just need really the item number. I think one of the biggest examples here, I didn't say example, but the calling cards, if you will, is that blue versus the charcoal black. Now, I'm going to go back just a couple of years on this because I can remember the last time I spent some time over at the Basel Watchwear, which for those of you who don't know is the biggest gathering of watch aficionados and manufacturers in the world. It's basically, yeah, it's six coliseums that are in Basel, Switzerland. Anyway, so you go if you want to see the latest and greatest and what's going on in watches. One of the big, I can't say big trends, but it was obvious it was coming.
Yeah.
Is if you looked at the high end, and when I say high end, five figure watches that are $30,000, $40,000, $50,000 a piece, and they're either doing the avant-garde and or they're doing the sport. And they're doing several major colors. There was the brown, there was the green, but then there was this one you could just see the tip of that iceberg. It was about to explode. Was this sky, not an electric blue or a royal blue or a midnight blue or any of the other blues. It was this sky blue, but it had more of an excitement. Like I think of it as more of kind of the electric influence in it.
Mm-hmm.
And the result against the black background was absolutely spectacular. And I think you guys have brought that to the table on this example in an absolutely major way, and you nailed it. You have absolutely celebrated that color combination, and you can see why it captivated the imagination and the excitement for the consumer and collector that is spending as much as a car on their watch. But now you guys are bringing this in. You're doing it, obviously, in the mechanical automatic example. Once again, 3D dial with new hot colors. Very nice job, man.
Well, Tim, this is our Esprit. Now, this is from our Lifestyles collection, our Esprit Zone, and earlier we just saw the Esprit de Vie, which was basically this watch on the bracelet. Now, the reason why you only see this in one color, the black, we did make other color choices, but this is the only one of the Esprits that is a certified limited edition, 250 units only, Tim. And if you take a look at the case back, you're going to see, we're going to show you that semi-exhibition case back here with the Citizen Miyota 8247 21 jewel mechanical automatic with the small seconds down there at the 5 o'clock. And here Tim is showing you now the case back. You'll see the Esprit name over there on the left side of your screen. And what number do we have here, Tim?
This one.
Let's see it on camera here.
Oh, wow.
What number? Let's see.
This is number one.
Wait a minute. Number one?
Yeah.
That is not supposed to happen. Mr. F, if you're watching, I'll bring it home. Anyway, there it is, limited edition number one, so you're not going to be able to get number one, but it is certified. You will get a certificate of authenticity. This is a hidden jewel again on this Mother's Day special with Tim Temple and the Jubilee. Unbelievable. This is a very significant 49mm, all black, and truthfully, we made the black one as the limited, the only one, because of request by Mr. Jim Skelton.
Let's do Sean in Pennsylvania. Sean, welcome to the show.
Hello.
Hey.
How you all doing?
Good.
Hello, Sean.
That was quick. I didn't expect you all switching on that quickly. Oh, let me turn my mute myself here.
Okay.
I just wanted to call and about your watch. It was one of the first Skeltonized ones I got, like Winchester Grand.
Sure.
And I love this thing. I'd sit there and just peek at it all day. I'd wind it up and cut it loose, you know. And it's got a sharp black strap. I really like that a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And it just goes on and on, you know. It has a lot of action in it, and the design was really nice on it, and front and back, you know, looking at it. And I love that kind of thing where you can see the action of the watch, you know, the mechanics of the watch. And the price was excellent.
Sean, we've kind of become known for our skeleton mechanicals here at ShopNBC. We've got more than 50 different models of skeleton mechanical automatics, and the Winchester Grand is certainly one of the biggest sellers we've had here.
Uh-huh. Yeah, it was ShopNBC has this great plan. It's really lucky for us people that are like on Social Security, for instance, and to be able to pay once a month, you know, on the day when the check comes in is great, you know, and it made it available for me. And that's one of the things I thought was really important to say, you know, is for us people that are on Social Security, have the availability of the watch, you know, and the price range is great.
Well, thank you for saying so, Sean. I appreciate that, and I'm glad you're taking advantage of the value piece, because I guess that is kind of the point.
Sean,
help everybody out there make the watches not only affordable from the price standpoint, but also from the payment standpoint. So, Sean, thanks for the great call, man. I do appreciate that. We've got just over 50 of these remaining. If you want to snag one, V91216. Beautiful, beautiful watch. That one is one of the things I like about it is that so few other than the extreme high end has done that blue with the black. And that one is, that's absolutely gorgeous. All right, this, we've shown you guys a couple of times, without a doubt, one of the hits of the whole show. 10978, 47 millimeter square, 316L steel, fantastic guilloche design across the dial. One of the big calling cards is now, with this new larger Aussie, you're also getting three interchangeable straps that does not require tools in any way. You just change them out. Available either the black or the silver, as you saw. Okay, moving into our next opportunity, this particular example is, as you can see, the Florio. And one of the things that I want to talk about right away on this one is that really cool, integration is probably the wrong way to describe it, but it's this contrast, the way you guys are setting up what goes on in the texture that, in this instance, one finds in the bezel of the watch versus that really aggressive texture that one is seeing in the dial of the watch. And even then, within the dial, you guys are talking about two or three different textures, which results in this just a visual feast by the time you guys are bringing it all to the table.
Absolutely. The dial work on this is amazing. It's done with vintage German machines. They're hydraulic presses. They're more than 35 years old now. And it takes true artisans to be able to actually operate those machines and make these dials. Our yield loss ratio on these dials, Tim, is 1-2. We literally will toss two dials away in the garbage for every dial that makes it into a watch. But you're so correct. If you take a look at the center texturization, it's what we call a Jaune Aquil styling, where it's got a little tinted design where it's like a tone on tone. If you flip it around, the different stripes actually change colors. Then you look at the exterior portion of the dial with the concentric circles, and then you've got that angled flange that's actually applied to the dial. You look at the little circular minute markers going around. It's those are all applied to the dial. And then, as you say, tying it into that bezel, it's kind of like a beadwork style bezel. It almost looks like a hammered bezel, but it's kind of a beadwork style. There's so much that goes into this. It's a race-inspired piece. If you take a look, you have no hour markers. The actual minute markers are what serve as your hour markers. And you'll notice it looks like a gauge of a car because you've got 60 at the top and the 30 at the bottom is kind of is upside down, like you see on a lot of race car type of things where they're just, circular. So it has that race-inspired look. If you look at the case overall, Tim, as a whole, okay, you've got this kind of cylindrical case with no lugs whatsoever. You've got the grooves on the side of the case right there, Tim. But then you take a look at the strap, there's no lugs. The strap just goes seamlessly right into the case. It's fantastic. We love this piece. I'm going to grab the brown. And as Tim pointed out, this is a mechanical automatic. It's not a quartz. So once again, another nice offering here on this Jubilee show, Tim, with Tim Temple right here.
Well, one of the things that I guess we need to talk about right away is the influence from the automotive industry,
right,
or I should say more specifically, I guess, the high-end the collector's car, the racing car industry, when we're talking about this kind of production. And you look at this on, you could not have picked a better day, I have to say, to wear the earth tones.
I can't believe it.
You've had more of the watches that are just dropping right in on this.
I'm telling you, Tim, you know what? I've never done this before. Guys that watch our shows all the time, they're used to my black coats and everything. But you know what? I let that guy sell me this coat and this suit, and I'm digging it now. This brown with this suit is hot. Look at that.
I'm going to go ahead and put on the black.
And that is 16-karat rose gold on the bezel, by the way, Tim.
I'm sorry, it's what?
It is 16-karat layering rose gold.
Now, the 16-karat, for those of you not familiar, means that they're using a bit more of additional alloy. It retains, actually, if anything, it increases the warmth of the rose gold, but it also lends to some durability of the gold, which, to say the least, when you're doing a layering process, becomes a very big advantage. Now, another subtlety on this I want to mention is I'm wearing the black. The black actually has more of an IP black that sweeps around the case. That's even more expensive than the gold, actually. Then the brown has the rose gold completely around the case, including
the
exhibition back.
Yeah, the bronze
tone. Okay, we got to put a last call on this because, frankly, we are out of time this hour. Next hour, we're going to show you today's top value extra, which is the brand new 52-millimeter slalom from the Alpine series. New dial design, new size, a lot of great firsts in this piece. 10482 till midnight tonight Eastern or sellout. Available in two different finishes, either the black or the silver. Details to follow as we get into that along with a lot of other Jubilee price products next hour. It's going to be a huge event. See you guys back in 2 minutes.
look good, feel better, and get ready for summer with ShopNBC's Summer Shape Up Weekend. Featuring a brand new appearance of the Sensa Weight Loss System, active wear from Arika, and a do-not-miss presentation of our best-selling fitness item, the Body Blade. Plus, visit ShopNBC.com for an even larger assortment of everything you need to get fit. Join us for the Summer Shape Up Weekend, right here on ShopNBC. May is the month of gold, and with ShopNBC, gold has never been more luxurious, alluring, and exciting. This May, tune in and take advantage of new designs, special pricing, and be sure to watch for a special edition of Gold Style every Thursday. It's all right here during May's Gold Month on ShopNBC. Style at home with Margie. Exotic global decor and high-quality home accent pieces at affordable prices. Rugs, furniture, floor screens, and Tiffany-inspired stained glass lighting pieces. Each item offers timeless beauty that is meant to be shared for years to come. Style at home with Margie on ShopNBC. It's smart, it's sensible, it's add and save shipping. The premium way to shop NBC with confidence. Now, when ordering multiple items, pay only one full shipping rate with your order. The rest of your items ship at 50% off regular shipping and handling. That's right, fill up your shopping cart with anything that Shop NBC has to offer and save big time on shipping. You spend time shopping and we'll take care of the rest. Be good to yourself. It's the premium way we exceed all your expectations. It's Shop NBC with confidence.
Everybody, welcome back into the show. Let's talk about watches for an hour. My name is Tim. Welcome to ShopNBC. Larry Magen from Stuhrling will be joining us in just a scant few moments, and we're going to be continuing with the big Jubilee celebration, which means special pricing basically on every single item. Also, please know that we're going to be doing roughly 10 to 12 items in the hour, which means we're going to be moving far faster than you usually see. This one, case in point, $159.22. A huge chunk of these are already gone. We showed you this a couple of hours ago. The few that remain are going to be up live in just the next few minutes. 45-millimeter case, exhibition back, and it is, as you can see, a mechanical automatic with double retrograde. And we'll get into a bit detail on that a little bit later on. Without a doubt, one of the hits of the entire day. I think it's actually going to be one of the hits of the entire event. This is the new Aussie. Now, this is a 47-millimeter, which is very large in the square. And it comes with three interchangeable straps. So you simply choose between the silver finish or the black. You get all three of the coordinated straps in one fantastic gift box. And you do it at just $109.78. That's not quartz again. That is mechanical automatic. This one is at $99.82. This is one of them, as you can see, already sold out. We'll have, I believe, black and silver is how they are being referred. $99.82 Jubilee price, down from $220, which I think is the regular. Be 90475. 90475. Take advantage of that offer. Okay, let's get underway. We're going to open up with today's top value extra. Check it out. Now, as we get into this, one of the first things I want to talk about is that there's going to be two different finishes, meaning you can get this in a black or you can get this in a white. Therefore, there are two different item numbers, V as in Victor, 91541. Now, both will be at 104.82, this in the black, as you can see, with either the red or the blue, or this one, which is done in the white or the steel finish, if you will, and this is done in the blue or the black.
Again, $104.82 is today's top value. Now, what does that mean? It means it's an exceptional price. It's, even for us, it's an unusually aggressive price. There are two key limits you need to be aware of whenever you see today's top value. One of them is quantity. I'll just randomly pick one here. Let's say this one, the silver with the black. Let's say that sells out first. All right, that offer's off the table. That won't come back. At midnight Eastern, irrespective of how hot and how popular, and that's already proven to be true, that these are, the whole offer comes off the table. So you guys really need to pick your favorite one and order. Again, two different item numbers. Larry, Megan joining me here at the table. As we were just talking about, obviously, we prior to the show, we think, you know, we think it's going to be a hit. How could it not be? But now, 2 hours in, we know you guys have another huge hit on your hands. You've done a lot of, you could call it upgrades or re-engineerings, or you've changed some concepts here. The larger case now, 52 millimeter. You've still maintained the big dome style, of course, the calling card. But now you've also done changes to the decoration on the movement. The mesh has come into play. There's a lot of big, big factors here.
Well, here, the new Alpine Slalom, one of our all-time signature pieces for Stuhrling Original is the Alpine. Many of you out there have purchased our Alpines in the past, the nice 44 to 45 millimeter case design. For 2010, now we came out with the new Alpine Slalom. I didn't realize we were going to do this top value extra, but I'm glad we are, because it gives everybody a chance who's owned the Alpine in the past to now step up into 2010 with Stuhrling Original. We're doing bigger, brasher, bolder statement pieces this year. Our designs are just getting just more and more spectacular, really, and this one is no exception, Tim. We've taken our traditional Alpine and we've brought it into 2010. 52 millimeter case design, and we freshened up that propeller style faceplate look. We've given it some of the, you know, new color designs as well. We put a nice mesh bracelet on this. And by the way, we haven't really mentioned it too much here, but for any guys out there, you know, a lot of times we get emails from guys, make stuff for the bigger wristed guys. I have a 9-inch wrist. I have a 9.5. I always have to buy longer straps. This will easily accommodate to a 10, 10.5-inch wrist with no problem. I've shown it already a number of times today, what it looks like on my wrist, and I'm a size 8 wrist. So, you know, don't be afraid if you're a 9, 9.5. It's not going to be any problem for you at all. In fact, you're going to love it. It's a statement piece. It is a mechanical automatic. It is a skeletonized mechanical automatic. Without going into any of the design features, Tim, just a skeletonized mechanical automatic at this price point is a value right there. And then you add in the domed crystal, the scalloped edges on the, you know, solid stainless steel case, the globular style crown, the chakram style bezel, the super luminova cigar style hands, the skeletonized propeller style faceplate. It's got all those characteristics. We're so proud of this piece. And the slope of the lugs, okay, just like the original Alpine, they wrap the wrist. They make it so comfortable, even in this large case size, Tim.
Now, this is something that, as you rightly point out, that was, I think, a big deal in the original, I guess if you want to call it that, the earlier version of this, which I memory serves as a 44 millimeter case. You've gone significantly larger here. Now we're down to the 52. But the big deal is by maintaining, for those of you who at home, you're not familiar with, you know, what's the big deal with the curved lug, or even what is a lug, I guess we could start with that. The lug area is where the bracelet or strap adjoins the case of a watch in simplest terms. Now, a lot of those either have no curve or a minimal curve, and what they've done in this particular offering is you guys have actually used a rather significant curve. Now, I can think of at least two reasons why immediately you guys at home are going to care about that. And one of the reasons is that aesthetically, I think given the overall literal kind of that globe and the bubble design and what have you, that it makes sense aesthetically. It ties it in. But there's a real practical side to that, too, as Larry illustrates here as he's wearing this happens to be the silver finish with the blue. It's equally true, of course, no matter the color you choose, is that the curved lug naturally folds, if you will. It brings the physical case down across the upper surface of the wrist, which means comfort at the end of it all, which is why you talked about the guys with the bigger wrist, and it's equally true, I suppose, for the guys or women that would choose to wear this with smaller wrists. That curve is really important because for both sizes, it helps fold the overall design around the wrist, and comfort means that you're going to wear the watch, and I've certainly talked about this on the show many times. You can have, I don't care, pick your brand, it can cost as much as a house, and if that watch is not comfortable, you're just not going to wear the thing. You're, at the end of the day, you're just not. I mean, yeah, you're going to wear it, and you're going to show it off for a little while. You're going to go, well, I don't like that so much. And it's going to sit around, and we know wherever you store it. Well, You guys take that really serious, and I think that is one of the key reasons why you see collectors coming back to Stuhrling over and over and over. And it's not just because you guys build great-looking watches and because they're so affordable and all of these wonderful things. It's because people love wearing them, and comfort's a big factor in that.
I don't know how you're going to pick your colors out there, folks, because there's not a bad choice in the bunch. Probably the most mundane is the one on the screen right there, silver and black. Okay, so if you're not into the wild, then the silver and black. But other than that, the other three are all out of the box, Tim. They really are. Look at this silver tone with this electric blue. Now, here's the black with the red, that electric candy red. I mean, I don't know, man. I just slapped it up here just to give you an idea, guys. You know, it's pretty hard to make a choice, Tim.
Which I guess is a good problem to have, and it also certainly speaks to when we talk about your design team, is that it's very, very rare that I've seen a Stuhrling image come up and I go, oh, that one's not so good. You just have, whether you're getting outlandish, which I think you could argue this is to an extent, or whether you're talking about the elegance and the classics, you guys know what the product is, and you know what the project was. This is going to be elegant. This is going to be regal. This is going to be more outlandish. And your colors are selected accordingly, and they're tied in beautifully. And as you rightly point out, let's take a look here, for example, at the black with the red. I mean, even right down to the accent that's on the crown, into the specific color that's engineered into the screws, which coordinates onto the dial. This is exactly the same way that I would describe if we had a watch here that sold for thousands of dollars. We would point these details out. And here's something where you can take the same concept, put it in a great design, but let's make it really, really affordable. So instead of just a handful of people being able to wear it, numerous people can collect them and wear them and really enjoy them.
Now, here's a really nice shot of the balance wheel. This is our ST90089, and it beats at 6 beats per second, which is 21,600 vibrations. And just below that, right in the center of the screen, that is the pallet fork that is releasing the power onto the regulator wheel into the drivetrain of the watch. Up in the upper right-hand corner up there, Tim, you can kind of see the mainspring there with some gaps in it. One of the nice things about owning a skeletonized mechanical with no battery is you can actually see the mainspring, which is what's powering the watch. Mm-hmm. So if you want to wind it by the crown, you have that option. You can wind it up, and as you wind it up, you'll see that mainspring just tightening up, you know, and that's one of the nice things about it is sharing. It's a conversation piece too, because you're sharing your appreciation for watchmaking everywhere you go.
You know, that's a really great point to bring up, and it brings to mind that one of the things I've had on my bar at home for a while is I've had a skeletonized pocket watch for exactly that reason. The people go, what's the big deal about watches? You can just pick the thing up and go, we'll check this out. You can wind it, you can see where the powertrain goes, you can see how the mainspring activates and so on. And this is exactly the same concept that's been built into this watch, only this time it's done in this really cool case, very contemporary and fun, and it is hot. This is a very powerful look in watches that typically have gone for a few thousand dollars and up. And here's a way where you guys can have a concept like this done all in 316L steel, which is surgical grade steel, with the color coordination, and do it at a special today's top value price. Now, please keep in mind, this is the final hour for the afternoon show, and I honestly don't know if this is going to be an evening show or not. It very well could be. But the time to order this is basically now. If you're not going to catch tonight's show for whatever reason, reserve as many of these as you can possibly use at the 10482, because the offer at 10482, irrespective of how popular, and we've certainly more than proven that this afternoon alone, at midnight Eastern, that whole thing goes away. So you've got two different item numbers. The silver finish is 91456, and you're choosing obviously between the blue or the black. And the alternate is 91541, and that's going to be the black finish, where you choose between obviously the red or the blue accents. That's the story on that. So this will be up for roughly 10 or 12 minutes, as you can see the Torino on the screen. And here's one of the things when we talk about Jubilee pricing. We had a terrific buy, for example, in a ladies' watch last hour. This time around, a bigger watch designed for the guys, but check it out at $89.24. And that's before you get to interest-free payments. In this instance, I believe it's just brown or white is how you're going to select it. This will be up a bit later on as well. This is done in I think it's under the word brown, but it's more like a bronze. It's a really interesting, very, very high-end color. Really an excellent choice at the lower left. Black or silver, I believe, is the other option on that. All right, this next one is one that I did manage to get a video out on Facebook a little bit earlier, and so we've already had a considerable response because of that. And incidentally, if you haven't joined me yet on Facebook, please do, and I'll give you a really good reason. One of the things I'm able to do is what's called ShopNBC Backstage Updates, where there's a new price or this new product or just a big, what I know is going to be hitting the show, didn't know until I actually arrived backstage, and I'm able to get some videos, and I post them out on Facebook, and of course, that's free, so you guys can check it out. Just join me, Tim Temple, on Facebook, and you can get the updates well in advance of seeing it in real time. So in this case, what we're taking a look at is a skeletonized automatic designed exclusively for women. Now, I will have to say, of the emails and general communication, yeah, whether somebody says hi on Facebook or they shoot me an email here at the network or whatever, I would have to say, overall, the number one question I have gotten from the female watch collector is, are you guys, meaning in general, as a company, are you guys going to be bringing in more of the skeleton pieces, the mechanical-oriented pieces, specifically for women? And I'm very happy to say that as a company, we are doing more and more of it. I think of all the brands that we work with, you guys have addressed this more aggressively, and I think earlier than any of the other brands have. And this is a beautiful example thereof. Now, we're going to show you four different colors. And I'll just list them, and let's just go, I guess, on the screen left or right. That is orange, white, black, and sky blue. So again, this is orange, white immediately next to it, black, and then the sky blue. Now, all of these have already had significant interest from being posted earlier on Facebook. So I'm going to tell you guys right now, there's not even 20 per color left, which I promise you on this show is next to nothing. So this is going to be out of here. So let's talk a bit more about this. I'm going to go ahead and grab the orange one here, but what I'll show you is absolutely applicable across the board. For example, if you look not just at the dial of this, but you're also looking at the back of it, one of the things you're going to see is that this has a hand, what's referred to as a handset back, which means that you've actually got an artisan to put this together, which means that in this particular instance, you've got screws on what's referred to as the corners, though in this particular instance, we're talking about a great many of them, not just even the four, which you usually see. I think it's double that or more. I think it's one, two, three, yeah, significantly more than that. I guess it's eight. So we're talking about a handset, hand-screwed back across this, plus its exhibition, plus you've got the hand decoration on the engine itself. Then you move this around to the front, and you check out the work that you guys did on the bezel and the skeletonized dial. It's no wonder that this is in process of selling out. You guys nailed it.
Yeah, well, this is our Madame Nemo. This is inspired by a very high-end Swiss brand. I believe the diamond carat weight is 35 points, if I'm not mistaken. Is that correct? 35 points?
I'm showing a quarter carat, but 32 diamonds, but
okay,
it could be.
32 diamonds, a quarter carat. Sorry, I stand corrected. But this is a very popular piece, and you are so correct, Tim. Stuhrling Original, we have been leaders in the watch industry as far as bringing not only mechanical automatics for the ladies, but skeletonized mechanical automatics for the ladies. And if you go with the ordering, either the orange or the white, you will get the rose gold layered bezel, mm-hmm, as well. So both the rose gold and the white, they're going by the strap color here, you do get the rose gold bezel. So it's a 20 jewel mechanical automatic skeletonized for the ladies, inspired by a very high-end Swiss brand with that octagonal bezel design that is so popular in the watch industry today, Tim.
But when you talk about the addition of, for example, the gold layering, as you point out,
right,
it's not just on the obverse. You guys chose to layer the back of the watch as well.
Case
and
back,
again,
mm-hmm,
that's available in the white and the orange only. So let me make that clear. Now, if you're choosing either the black or the sky blue, they're all, of course, built from 316L steel. Mm-hmm. They're all done in the same size, which is about a 35-millimeter case. But you won't see the coordinated gold. I happen to have the orange one here. You can see that obviously there's gold and there's more gold added into the rotor. And there you see more of the gold across the top. This is a quarter carat of diamonds plus the mechanical automatic plus all of the additional attention to detail and expense of this level of construction in the case,
yeah,
at 157. That is a beautiful,
yeah,
beautiful buy. And I'm glad to see that so many of you
took advantage of it. All near colorless and eye clean diamonds as well, Tim.
That is one of those watches that there is no way when you're wearing that someone's going to go, it's about $150. No way. That it looks so high-end. Beautiful job. All right. The host pick coming up, of course, a bit later on. Blue already sold out. A few left of the silver. A few left of the black. This is a very big power rectangle presented on a 316L steel bracelet. And, of course, one of the great features happens to be marked down to 9882. Now, this next watch, one of the... Man, there's so many features on this. It's kind of like what what to begin with. This is cool. The dial has got to be one of the big stories here. It's a multiple level dial, but even within that, we're talking about multiple finishes and, frankly, just the look of it being very, very high end. Now, there are, I believe we still have all three, so we're going to start with three color choices here. There's the blue and the silver tone and the rose tone. Now, in this case, I happen to be holding the silver tone. The silver tone, by the way, it is true the dial is a silver white, but you're going to see a lot of the charcoal black accents. For example, the outer track case in point is all done in charcoal, and one of the frames that helps out with the retrograde is all done in charcoal, and so on and so forth. So this one is the silver tone. Now, blue is going to have basically the all silver dial, but the big difference is that you're going to see blue markers and blue hands utilized there. And last but not least, we've got rose tone down on the end. And of course, that means the heavy layering of the rose gold, mm-hmm. which in this instance, you guys did both obverse and reverse, which means that the case of this particular watch looks like it's done entirely out of a big block of rose gold, which I appreciate, because to me, that's kind of the point. Mm-hmm. I understand why some brands only layer the top, frankly, because it's cheaper, but it also means you can never show your watch off but from this one exact angle, and the fact that you guys do the all-over layering really completes the illusion of the solid gold case, and I know it cost you guys more money to do it, but I think it's a smart way, it's the better way to go, and I'm glad that you guys did. Mm-hmm. Bigger case in this instance with the 45mm, mm-hmm. Again, reflecting what is the demand in current market. Guys want the bigger, heavier cases. Then you add the look of the tourbillon and the retrogrades. You put a lot of high-end stuff into this thing.
Yeah, well, this movement is not an inexpensive movement. It's a 33-jewel mechanical automatic. It's even got, if you see the little ball bearings on the rotor as well, Tim. If we come in real tight on this case back shot right here, I don't know if we're able to get that tight and see it, but you can actually see the little ball bearings in there. It's really one of our finer mechanical automatic movements that we do. You probably have to maybe undo the strap or something like that. But they're in there, guys. Believe me. You see the perlage treatment on the back plates as well. But this has a mechanical automatic with no battery, no computer chip, and it's giving you a retrograde day of the week complication and a retrograde date complication off of the same mechanical automatic. You have a flywheel over the balance wheel so that it's synced to the second hand, which gives you the faux tourbillon effect. Mm-hmm. We've got what we call the bow tie bridge. This is what I call our tuxedo execution because of that whole, you know, that black and white look that you have going on there. But there's absolutely no question. The number one seller for the last 2 years has been what has been called the blue. It's the all silver tone. You don't have a two-tone dial, and it's got the blue hands and blue markers. But, you know, today, since I'm wearing my earth tones, I'm going to grab the rose tone with the 16-karat rose gold. I don't do a lot of browns, but here it is, and this, is, by the way, is the, you know, a very popular seller as well, Tim, is the rose gold with the brown.
Yeah, I think in some of your series has been by far the number one seller because there is that opulence that's naturally associated with the rose.
This piece, you know, for us has been, it has become the signature piece of our boardroom collection. It's from what we call our Labyrinthian series in the boardroom collection, and that refers to the, you know, double mill, double step design bezel. We have four or five models with that double mill, including the Brumalia, by the way. But this piece here, the Saturnalia, has become the signature of our entire boardroom collection. It has that kind of a look to it. It's just so rich and so opulent, as you pointed out, with that intricate bezel and all these multi-complications going on. It's sensational. And when this piece first came out, it was more than double this price. So we've been able to master this piece now and get this down to a price where everybody can afford it. And look, with the payment options here in the Jubilee, this mm-hmm. makes it, everybody gets a chance to bring one home now.
Yeah, where everyone can actually afford the concept of luxury, which is a pretty cool thing. Hey, let's grab a phone call or two here. Bill from California, how are you?
I'm doing great, Tim and Larry. You know, I picked up that beautiful, from Jim's Photographs, which really did an amazing job. I picked up that beautiful Pro Challenger, is it called, Larry?
The Challenger Pro, yes.
Oh, man, that is a beautiful, gorgeous watch. I cannot wait to get that. It is just stunning. And I got a couple months ago. I have the rose tone and the white with the blue hands, the Saturnalias. I get a lot of compliments on those watches.
Mm-hmm.
And, yeah, I mean, I've got everything, Larry, the Bromelias, and, I mean, you name it, and I'm a big El Capo fan. I have the black. I have the rose tone black. Oh, man, I love those watches. Any chance, Larry, you'll ever make a capo on a bracelet by any chance?
Well, it's funny you should ask because we actually have one coming. I'm hoping we're going to land it in time for our next rotation, which is going to be in about 3 weeks on May 28th or 29th. We're hoping to have it here in time for that show. If it's not here for that one, we're probably going to see it in June. It's the El Capo on a bracelet, Bill.
Oh, I can't wait, Larry. There was another photo that Jim had on Watch Geeks. Is it the Meridian? Is that the one that's kind of a square watch with the orange accents, or I have the name wrong? I'm wondering when that might be coming out, if you know the one I'm speaking of.
Well, the Regatta Meridian is certainly not square. It's a 49-millimeter round case design. As far as the square watch goes, I'm not sure which one you're referring. Oh, you're talking about the Aranax. We hope to have that here in three weeks. We hope to have
fantastic.
That here on our next rotation.
And Tim, hey, I'm glad to talk to you. I follow you on Facebook.
Thanks, man.
You're great. And lastly, Larry, the real reason I called, I love your watches, but you ought to branch off because your suits, man, I want to get a Larry Magen suit. I love
you need the Larry Magen. Need the look.
Man, that suit you have on with the red tie, it's gorgeous, Larry.
Well, you know, I don't do a lot of the earth tones. I let the salesman talk me into it, you know.
You might want to rethink.
You know, it's a little different look, you know, but I'm kind of digging it.
I love it. I love it. And I love your watches. God bless you. And keep making them. I love them all.
Thank you very much, Bill.
Hey,
much love to you.
Thanks for the great call, man.
Thank you.
Appreciate that. By the way, if you guys want to join us here, just call a toll-free number, and we'll see if we can't get you out here for about a minute or so. So let's do a quick update here as we prepare to move on. If you want the blue, we're down to the very last handful. In fact, there's like half a dozen or something like that, and that is the one all the way to the right. It's named blue because it has the blue-colored markers and the hands. Rose tone will be the next to go, very likely. Got maybe a dozen of that, and that's it. These special offers, by the way, a lot of times they were brought in some smaller quantities, and so when these are gone, they're out of here. So do take advantage of them. Now, this is a Vermilion, am I pronouncing that correctly?
Yes, Vermilion.
This is one of these things that really, in my estimation, it celebrates the skeletonization of dial, the physical skeletonization of movement and coordinating the two and balancing the two. Debuting tonight, I believe, at 8 p.m. Eastern, 7 Central, and just a gorgeous, gorgeous, kind of an aggressive dress look.
And you notice that's the exact same case as the Saturnalia, the 45 millimeter with the double step mill, double step bezel. Okay?
Coming up tonight, we finally get to see it. Watch Time with Jim Skelton, in which you get the Tourbillon, which I'm guesstimating is going to be a cozy couple of minutes. Prior to that, 7 p.m., Perfect Sleep with Serta. And next hour, in just about 35 minutes, the Sensa Weight Loss System is going to be joining us. So a great and varied lineup here at ShopNBC. My name is Tim. Thank you for joining us this afternoon. Larry Magen from Stuhrling, obviously along for the ride as well. And you're also back this evening.
Yep.
Along with Michael Davis from Invicta. So all sorts of frivolity in store a bit later on. All right, $89.24. I'm just going to start with a price on this because part of Jubilee pricing is every once in a while you guys will just like that $50 one for the women last hour, which is just nutty. Mm-hmm. And for those of you who missed it, I don't think we're bringing it back, but you can check it out on ShopNBC.com. That was, believe it or not, a diamond dial watch for $50. But this one, in my estimation, you first look at it, you go, well, it's a guy's watch, and I don't necessarily disagree with that. But at the same time, I think because so many women now are wearing the bigger, more aggressive looks, that this is a way where anybody interested in a big power look, you can get into it. You've got a really different approach to the poly, for example, in the straps. Mm-hmm. This is not just a flat finish, or it's not just a reptilian. You guys actually did almost like a distressed stone kind
of
look.
Well, you know, it's funny you say that, Tim, because that's kind of how I describe it myself, as more of a cobblestone look. You know, Jim says it's more of a rhinoceros skin. But whatever you want to call it, I called it like a cobblestone impression on the rubber strap.
Don't know.
But it's a beautiful silicone rubber strap, Tim, and it's integrated seamlessly to the case. As you can see, we're very big on the case integration, as you've seen model after model here. But this is from our Italia series in our Lifestyles collection. So it's more of the casual lifestyle. Wear this with jeans and a t-shirt, a polo shirt, knock around, great every day, with a Swiss movement as well, Tim.
So for somebody, I think it's fair to say that you're looking for one of the big bargains of the hour. You absolutely want to consider this just from the Swiss standpoint alone or from some of the unique features that are built in.
Oh, did I pull that out of the shot? I'm sorry.
Okay, so let, you know what?
Sorry,
let's just
guys.
Do some real basic stuff here, if we may. We're going to show you guys options today. One is the white and black, which is the one I happen to have in front of me, and the other is brown and rose, which is the one that Larry is showing you at the moment. It is also the one that is the most limited at the moment. Each of them is a 49-millimeter case. They're all built in 316L steel, as you already mentioned. There's the Swiss movement that's involved. Cristerna crystal. Cristerna, in simplest terms, very durable material.
Very shatter-resistant.
Very shatter-resistant. Mm-hmm. If you think of, for example, in sapphire, sapphire is the hardest material, but not the most durable thing in the world. Then you've got mineral, where it's more durable, but you don't have the scratch resistancy. I think Cristerna is right in between the two.
Good call.
A really great material, especially for a company like yourself that is designing watches to really last at the same time be affordable. It's a great way to go. And let's grab another couple of calls here. Larry from Massachusetts standing by. Larry, hi.
Hi, Tim.
Yes, sir.
Hi, nice to talk with you and Larry.
Hi,
nice
Larry.
You and talk with you also. I just called in to, first of all, give accolades to you, Larry. I've had talks with you on the phone and have your direct number. You're just a very hands-on fellow who runs a great, great company.
Thank you very much. It takes a village, Larry.
Well, I'm sure it does. I own a business myself, and I have for 35 years.
Yeah.
And you're only as good as you are people, and you have good people, great people, and a great product. I'll make this quick, Larry. You're talking about the new Alpine on the mesh bracelet,
mm-hmm.
and I have an older Alpine, but on this mesh bracelet, will it fit a wrist that's say 7.5 inches?
I would say 7.5 is the bare minimum, and that's going to really come down to depend upon on you. There will be some 7.5s that say, oh, I love it, I have no problem. There's going to be other guys at 7.5 is going to say, I'm not happy with this, or I'm not comfortable with this because I don't like to have this much strap hanging out. So it's going to depend on you. I would say to be safe, I would call it 7.75 and up on the Alpine Slalom. However, I don't want to paint it as an absolute because every time we do that, I will get emails after the show for the weeks that follow is, well, you said not to go down to sevens. It won't work on this watch or that watch. I took a chance and I love it. You shouldn't say that because I love it. This happens every single time we do that. So there will be some people at 7.5. The bottom line is this. On the last hole on that bracelet, it'll fit a 7.5. It will. However, it's going to depend upon you, Larry. Really?
Sure. No, I will understand what you are saying. I don't know. I've tried to follow every show that you're on. I don't know if you have shown the Metropolitan.
We showed the Metropole during the first hour here with Tim, or was it the second hour? I forgot. But we did show the Metropole last night. No, we didn't have the Metropole Elite here, though. Just the Metropole.
Yeah, well, I have the Metro. Is it Metropolitan? It's the with the small second disc.
Oh, that's the Metropolis. That's the Metropolis, Larry.
I'm sorry. That is a fantastic timepiece. I every time I wear that watch out, I get stopped by several people wanting to know what it is and just look at it.
Yeah.
Larry, your company is a great innovator, and again, your customer service is beyond reproach.
Well, thank you so much,
Larry. Everybody, if they haven't tried Stuhrling, by all means, just pick one up, and I think that they'll be extremely impressed. And I want to thank you for your personal attention in my affairs, and also I know on WatchGeeks.net, I'm for watches only, and we love to hear from you, too. So
well, thank you so
very
much for the love, Larry. Thank you. Much love to you.
Thanks for the call, Larry. We do appreciate that. And he has some really valid points in there, not the least of which is, we haven't talked about that a lot, your customer service is phenomenal. You take very, very good care of your customers.
You know, it's a challenge, Tim. It's not easy. And we've grown a lot, and we've made a lot of improvements, and we're still working on it, too.
Last call on this guy is 8924, and that's before you get to the interest-free payments choosing either the white or the brown. Actually, it's called Brown Rose. You should know that one in particular is in a very limited array. All right. Now, last call on the ladies' diamond watch. It also happens to be a very beautiful skeletonized mechanical automatic. While we do have all four of the colors, I can tell you that the majority, the rose, not the rose, the orange in particular, I think is very, very close to being gone. This is at 157.18. Now, keep in mind, at 157.18, you've got a mechanical automatic that is custom-built for women with a skeletonized dial, skeletonized movement, and a quarter carat of diamonds. It's absolutely stunning watch, and especially in the ones built only for women, I think it is arguably one of the best deals in current inventory. It's beautiful stuff. Now, this one is 91545. Actually, what we're going to be showing you is two different versions or examples, if you will. So 91545, that's going to be one that's unique unto itself. Now, you'll need to mention maroon because it was named after the strap, so kind of keep that in mind. And the other option is 91189, 91189. Now, under that example, you're going to have an option of brown. Actually, it's called brown. And then we've actually got one called black and white. So those are the two you see, one right next to the other there. All right, so moving beyond that, let's get into some of the things that they do have in common. We've seen this on a few of the other examples in the course of this afternoon's show. For example, the double retrograde. This is a mechanical automatic. This is therefore the one that you're going to wind up, though for those of you not familiar, that guy you see bouncing around there, that's called a rotor, and if you were to wear this every day, it would help keep the mainspring wound, hence the nickname automatic. This particular one is heavily layered in the rose gold. That's not necessarily true of all of them. I happen to be showing you the one under the word maroon, which has its own item number. Now, some things that they all have in common, built in 316L steel, all with exhibition back, with a width on this case of approximately, I'm thinking either 49 or 50 millimeter, fairly deep dish dial. The story on the dial, of course, and this is so true of many Stuhrlings, is multiple, not so much finishes in this example, but multiple textures, plus the fact that you guys are using, again, three-dimensional architectures, adding some of the crescents that are custom-built and then inset separately. Historically, very expensive dials have done this, and it's really refreshing to see a brand like yourself that is stepping up and really making this sort of a sophistication so much more affordable.
Absolutely, Tim. Now, this is from our Apocalypse series. We call it the Spirit. And this is a 46 to 47 millimeter case size. If you go 10 to 4, it's 46. But it plays much larger because you have case extensions at 3 and 9 and case extensions at 12 and 6. So it plays much larger than a 46. And you might have recognized when Tim was showing you the back of the watch, that rotor design and the movement. This is the exact same movement that we just saw a few minutes ago in the Saturnalia, which was a very dressy timepiece with the retrograde day of the week and the retrograde date. Here's that exposed balance wheel with that flywheel that synced to the second hand with the bow tie bridge. And we've put it in a very industrial looking case, our Apocalypse case, a very sport style case, beefy case. So it's kind of like, the Apocalypse meets the Saturnalia, and now what you have is you have the Spirit. And here's probably the most versatile execution that I'm wearing, which we're calling black and white on that particular item number right there. But again, it's that same movement we just saw, that very high-end 33-jewel mechanical automatic. Okay, with the retrograde day of the week over there at the 2 o'clock position and the retrograde date indication over there at 10, all working off of a mainspring. And here it is in our most popular case design. Let me pull that keeper all the way underneath. But our most popular case design, the Apocalypse case, Tim.
And let's come back and talk a little bit about retrogrades, because I just think they're a very regal, kind of an elegant feature. And again,
definitely,
historically, usually you're on four-figure watches, five-figure watches, and so on. So what are we talking about here? Well, we're talking about are these crescents you see at the 2 o'clock and the 10 o'clock. And in this particular model, obviously it varies per the watch, but in this particular model, the one at the 10 o'clock position is going to give you the date of the month, which runs 1 through 31, of course. And over here we have the day of the week. Now, how this works is these hands will move, in this instance, for example, 1 through 31. When it hits 31, it's going to bounce back down to the 1. And on this, once it reaches Sunday, it would conclude Sunday, obviously, at midnight into Monday, and that drops back down there. So that's basically what a retrograde does. And I think it's this really elegant, wonderful approach to overall dial design and concept. And it's something that I think on this series, because we've actually shown several today, gorgeous, absolutely beautiful, beautiful design. Now, this one is actually back in stock. A little bit of background. It actually debuted in April and sold out in about 1 minute. Now, what are we talking about? We're talking about specifically a tourbillon. And this is to be clear, this is not, you know, it looks like a tourbillon. This is an actual tourbillon. Now, in preview mode, I really can't get into what a tourbillon is. But, you know, Google it or whatever, and you can learn more about it. Otherwise, tonight, you'll see a little bit more at 8 p.m. Eastern as Watch Time with Jim Skelton hits the screen, debuting this tourbillon among several other very key Stuhrlings, and some Invictas are in there, and just general, I guess, a big variety of watches. So that should be fun for you guys. So getting into this offer here that we've got in front of us, 47-millimeter case, I think that's got to be, I don't know if it's the factor, but it's got to be one of the factors that's making this one of the biggest selling pieces you guys have done in this particular visit. You combine that with choices where somebody can choose either the black or the silver, and then you add in the three interchangeable straps. So we're talking about the bigger, more aggressive look, a lot of additional variety, but at the same time, I think you really maintain what made this so hot when you look at it historically.
I agree.
The skeletonization, and in particular, I got to say, the ultra-detailed guiche design dial.
Absolutely, Tim. You know, the Manchester Aussie really is all about the rainbow-colored numerals. Now, yes, we did some monochromatic executions where we didn't do the rainbow numerals, but it was the rainbow numeral effect that started it all. We had a silver version with a navy strap, and then we did a black with the rainbow numerals like you're seeing right here on your screen here. And that was in a 41 by 41. So we still have those exploding numerals with the rainbow multicolored going around the dial, and it's really one of the highest end, most popular looks out there. It's been around for about 5 years at least that I know of. And there's a lot of watch companies that are taking their whack at that look. Some of them are using pastel colors. We use the jewel tones. Some are using earth tone colors. And then what we did to make it our own, Tim, because, you know, you have to make it your own, is we did what you're talking about, the guilloche soleil pattern, mm-hmm. which is the sunray texturization on the dial. And we put the jewel tone numerals. Now, with the new Manchester Aussie Sport. In the office, we like to call this one the Wizard of Aussie, Tim. Mm-hmm. But the Manchester Aussie Sport, we did it with a skeleton. What we're known for is our skeleton mechanical automatics. We never did the Aussie in a skeleton before, and we went large. This is a 47 by 47. We kept the integrity of the case design with that beautiful curvature that is so comfortable on the wrist, okay? But we bumped it up to 47 by 47, which gives you a 53-millimeter case equivalency. So you hear 47 and you think, oh, that's not so big. But take a look on Tim's wrist here, guys and gals, how big this is. And by the way, ladies like this piece too, even in the larger size. It is fashionable. It is fun. Listen to the right voices. You'll make the right choices. I'm here to tell you what's up. And guys, I'm telling you now, you will love this piece. Since I've got mine for the last 2 weeks, Tim, I'm wearing it every day in the mm-hmm. office. Whether we have, you know, meetings, whatever, it doesn't matter. I'm loving mine.
Well, I got a quick quantity update for you guys. I was going to tell you there's fewer than 100. In fact, if you want the black, there's now down to fewer than 50. So it's pretty
wow.
obvious. The black, yeah. The black is very likely to be the one
check
to,
this
to
out
go
on the
first.
Wrist.
You don't need, and I'm sure somebody's asking, any tools whatsoever if you're going to be changing out the strap. So if you want to move from the black to the blue or the red or whatever, it just takes a relative few seconds. It's got what's called a quick change pin on the back, which is something that basically you work with your fingernail, and it's very easy to change out from one strap to the next and so on. So again, you simply choose, do you want the silver finish or the black finish? You'll automatically get all three of the straps, and you are getting the new, I guess to date, the biggest Aussie that's ever been made. This is the 47 millimeter. Now, a really quick update here in regards to the today's top value, more specifically the today's top value extra. It's available in two different colors. You get it either in the black or the silver. But I got to tell you that there's already down to fewer than 100 remaining, which basically means that, too, is very close to being sold out. So fewer than 100 of the red or the blue. If you want the black, similar story going on here. A few more, I think. But actually, that may not be true in the silver with the blue. This one, actually, I'm now told it's the opposite. We're closer to like 50 of these left. So basically, this is going to go. It's 104.82. This is the bigger choice, 52 millimeter in the case, which is to date the largest Alpine that's been built. It also has, of course, as you rightly point out, it has the newer Skeleton decoration has the newer dial concept that's going on. Mm-hmm. And it's also designed to fit bigger wrists now, as you rightly point out, the 9.5s, 10s, and so on. So beautiful job. Very close to being sold out. Okay, back to topic at hand. We've got barely 15 minutes left with you guys. This one, in my estimation, we're really seeing a nice homage towards some of the high-end sport watches, especially they were really hot in the 90s into the 21st century, my estimation. I also think this is going to be, I can't speak to tonight one way or the other, but I believe this is going to be the only opportunity by which I'm going to be able to actually show you guys a moon phase.
Right.
And so this is a genuine moon phase, which means, by the way, it follows the 29.5 day cycle of new moon and full moon and so on, and that's located at this particular model at the 6 o'clock position. Mm-hmm. In addition to that, you've also got the second hand, you've got the date of the month and the day of the week, and also the month of the year. So anybody that likes collecting, and I'm certainly among them, the watches that have all bells and whistles with a lot of different little features and little cool tricks that it can do, this is going to be an outstanding selection for you guys to consider and to be able to do so at a really inexpensive price point. And all you have to do is ask for the item number, which in this particular case, as you can see, is 90300. And very accurately, I think you guys named this the multifunction, which is that's just calling it exactly what it is.
Well, this is a super opportunity with this Jubilee pricing, Tim. This is our Artemis Gentile, and it comes from our classic collection in our Heritage series. And a lot of guys out there who are regular followers of the shows and what have you, they like to know, is this an ETA, a Ronda, an ISA movement, a Citizen Miyota, what kind of movement? This is actually from a company called Technotime, Tim, and I know you're...
Really?
Yeah, and I know
I know
you're very familiar with Technotime. But to be able to pick up this master calendar with genuine moon phase, Technotime movement at this price, even forget about the solid, link bracelet that you have here with the angled links, this is a real sleeper in the show here, guys. Don't miss this. Very dressy piece. Many of you have seen our Artemis, which is essentially this piece, but on a leather strap. The Gentile now gives you the nice angled link bracelet, which is much more expensive to do. And then you're picking up a Swiss quartz movement from Technotime with a master calendar. What is a master calendar? It is day, date, and month. Plus, not just an AM, PM, sun, moon, it's a genuine moon phase that tells you when the full moon is coming, Tim. So this is a tremendous opportunity, great for business casual, great for every day. This can you tie it together with a suit, whatever you want to do. This is great value right here, Tim.
Yeah, those of you that are familiar with Technotime, you're probably dialing madly to grab one of the last of these. Technotime is an ultra high-end company. They build, for example, tourbillons for other companies that literally sell for 60, 80, 100 grand. That's astonishing to get this. Let's say hi to Dave King standing by. Dave, what up?
Shake, shake, shake. Shake, shake, shake. Shake your sansa. Yeah, shake your sansa. Hey, we have got an amazing opportunity coming your way next hour. If you're one of the thousands of people here at ShopNBC or the millions of people who have lost pounds across the country, we would love to hear from you because Sensa is in the house. We're talking about a weight loss system that is not only proven today, but proven tomorrow and proven for day after day after day. And it's so easy to do. You have to change anything. All you do is a little shake, shake, shake. Shake it on everything that you eat, and that's it. You're going to be astounded at the results. It is based on science. Dana Devon's going to be here. And again, we'd love to hear from you on our testimonial line when we get there next hour, because you're going to be talking about Sensa at the best price ever. We'll tell you all about that coming up next hour. Back to the fellas.
Hey, thanks, Dave. And Dave's joining you, by the way, in about 15 minutes, and we'll get underway, obviously, with the Sensa program. My name is Tim, and welcome to the show. Larry Magen from Stuhrling joining us as well. And let's get into the expedition. Now, one of the first things, I guess, to open things up here is to talk a bit about what has become so very, very sought after in, I would say, sport watches in the realm of, I guess, anywhere from $4,000 to $10,000 in steel. Now, obviously, noble metals go higher. But the really aggressive crown protectors have become something that a lot of the watch collectors, a lot of the consumers look for, and you guys have not only brought one out that introduces that concept, but you're going even farther. Yours is actually signed for Stuhrling. Now, why do I start with that particular idea? Well, first of all, I want you guys at home to know, if you're not familiar, that having this elongated and very aggressive crown protector is an upscale feature. But the signed factor takes it to a whole nother level. Why? Because when you sign something like this, like, for example, a signed case or crown protectors or what have you, what happens is that you've basically committed yourself. Because if you don't go as far as that additional engraving, let's say you do a product, whatever it is, and it doesn't hit, well, you can just put it on something else. The reality is once you've signed it, you can't really take that back once it's been engraved three-dimensionally. It becomes very cost prohibitive to try to alter that. And it really, I think, speaks to the fact that you guys were absolutely committed. At the same time, you wanted to add a lot of the high-end concept, like in this case, the signed crown protectors and so on and so forth. Let's do this. Let's grab a quick phone call. We'll get a bit more into this as well. Tom from Florida standing by. Tom, hi.
Going.
Hello, Tom.
I just want to say thank you, Tim and Larry, for putting on such a great show of Stuhrling watches.
No, you're very
and,
welcome. Thank
you, I have a quick question about the Saturnalia.
Okay.
I've got a fairly small wrist, about a 6 3/4 or so, mm-hmm. and I'm wondering, would that fit me okay, or would it be too loose on me?
Believe it or not, I think you could probably pull it off. But the nice thing about shopping with ShopNBC is you have the 30-day no questions asked return policy. I think that's the kind of an issue you're going to have to try on. Will it actually fit on the strap? I would say yes. What I'm concerned about more than the strap is it's a 45 millimeter case. That's not
right.
It's pretty good size.
Yeah, so, and I do have some watches that are fairly good size, so that to me is not really an issue. But I'm more concerned about strap than I am head size. But I like the 45, 42 to 45 size. So,
mm-hmm.
Okay. Well,
I think you have to try it on, to be honest with you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Very good. Well, gentlemen, thank you very much. So I listen to the right voices. So I'll hope I'm making the right choices.
Thank you, Tom.
Hey, thanks,
very
Tom.
Much.
I appreciate that. Thank
much
you for
love
the great
to you.
Call. I'll try
back
to get to one
you.
More call between now and the top of the hour. I'm not sure we're going to be able to do that, but we'll see. Keep in mind that if you're ordering this one actually right now, you are actually going to save more than $65 off the regular ShopNBC price, so it's a great time to certainly take advantage of this. Three different colors from which you can choose is the black and black, the silver tone and black, and the silver tone and the brown. The one I happen to be wearing is the silver tone and the brown. Now, let's talk about this brown for a second.
Sure.
This is not, to my estimation anyway, I don't think of that as the chocolate brown. This is much more of a bronze. It's a
yes.
very kind of a, almost an antiquity sort of an approach. It's a very warm, very rich color.
Yeah, the bronze tones are just fantastic. They're just so unique. And I mean, now we're seeing more and more companies do it. But we started about 2 years ago. And like I said earlier, I can't remember exactly which was the first one we did it. But I would say the Expedition was probably one of the first three models that we used the bronze tone. PVD. It's brown PVD, which gives a rich bronze tone, so it's gorgeous.
Last call on this one. Please note the item number V90692. Silver tone with the black, by the way, is the one very, very close to being sold out. Maybe a dozen or so left, and that's going to be it. All right. Last call on the ladies' skeletonized mechanical automatic just happens to have a quarter carat of diamonds featured on this example as well. 157.18. It's single digits in all of them. And I'm kind of surprised that orange one's hanging in there, but it is. So it's orange, white, black, and sky blue, the four mm-hmm. different choices. Single digits in each one. And when that's gone, that's gone. I got to tell you, just on just a personal commentary, I think that watch is absolutely stunning, especially that kind of price point.
Well, you know,
we're
doing more, you know, with that inspiration, with that octagonal case on both sides, the men's and the ladies'. We just came out with our lady, the Lady Nemo last rotation. That was a big hit here. So it's gorgeous, Tim. What do we got here? Oh, okay, the Charing Cross Elite.
Well, part of, I think, the obvious brilliance here is the massive discount. I mean, the regular price on this, for those of you following such things, and I don't mean the MSRP.
Just wow.
The regular ShopNBC price is $230. Anybody that's acting during the Jubilee, it's the identical watch, identical warranty, identical packaging, nothing changes, except you can buy as many of these as you can use until sellout, at $99.82. And then we're going to step up with what we call ValuePay. So what is ValuePay? ValuePay is a series of interest-free payments, and it's sponsored by ShopNBC. And it's a way to get in on a myriad of items here. Obviously, I'm featuring watches right now. But the point is you can pay it out over the next several months, and ShopNBC does not charge any interest to do that. Now, we're talking in this instance about a nice variation of what I consider a to-no case, though I guess you could also argue for the rectangle as well. Both of them are considered wonderfully dressy, very high-end concept. In fact, the to-no made a major comeback in the 90s after one very, very high-end horologist actually really, really ran with it, and I believe that still sticks around today. Now, all that stated, I think you guys added a beautiful flair when you move beyond the texture dial that we're seeing, the fancy case, the solid back, handset screwed in, all of these wonderful things, and we get to the bracelet itself.
Yeah.
Now, we're seeing, obviously, two different choices here. I happen to be showing you the black and black, but the point is, you guys are doing that really cool angled concept, moving through each one of these links. Again, another nod to a very high-end production.
Absolutely. These angled links absolutely are an homage to a very well-known bracelet design. But I just was informed, Tim, that we're down to only the black, which, you know, I mean, if you're... you know, looking at, you're one of those kind of guys that you want to get the most bang for your buck. The black actually cost more to produce, and you're still getting it at this Jubilee offering here. So the black PVD is more expensive than the all stainless steel. But in any case, it's a great, great everyday timepiece. It's the Citizen Miyota OS20 movement with the three register chronograph. You have the 24-hour indication at 3 o'clock. You've got your small seconds at 6 o'clock. You do have your minute counter at 9 o'clock. And you'll notice all those subdials have the applied subdial rings. It's got what we call kind of like a harlequin center texturization in the center. Mm-hmm. And then we've got those angled, you know, hour chapters, hour markers on the dial. If you hold it kind of horizontal, doesn't really matter, keep it the way it is, but it gives you that Union Jack look to it because, you know, Charing Cross is dead center of London, okay? And so it has that Union Jack look to it. We've got the Charing Cross design on the case back as well. This literally goes from, stretches from one end of the wrist to the other. It's a very, very striking looking timepiece, great for every day in the office. You've got a reliable movement in this piece with that Citizen Miyota OS20. So
yeah, no,
I am absolutely shocked when we see this for under $100. I mean, this is a super value among values here today, Tim.
You know, one of the things I've got to point out here is the kind of the tactile experience when you pick this up, because the finish that you've selected for the steel and ergo the IP plating resulting, It almost feels like ceramic.
Now, again, very much
I'm not saying it's ceramic, but it really, really feels
it's
like
it's because of the high polish. You're absolutely right, Tim. And the black is like, it's like liquidy, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's like a liquidy finish to it, and it's got the flexibility. It's so soft. I mean, it's not a stiff stainless steel link bracelet at all. But at this kind of a price point, I don't want to get it caught into trying to oversell the piece. Because it's not necessary. Look at the styling on the pushers on the piece as well, Tim. The engineering, the design elements of the pushers, the way they kind of just, you know, lead to the crown like that. They've got the extra angle on there as well. So the design elements, you got a solid movement, the look of the piece, the stainless steel angled link bracelet, it's all there. It's just, you know, a great opportunity. I mean, we were literally selling this piece for a much higher price for a long time. And this is not something that we're just trying to clear out, by the way, Tim, because, you know, the Charing Cross has been a staple in our collection for, over 3 years at least.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so, and it's not going away. I mean, this is a very popular piece in our collection.
Well, when you look at this as we've been ramping up to it over the last couple of hours, actually almost 3 hours, and we show this in previous. When we began this, we had three different versions. We had the blue and the silver tone, and we had the black and the silver tone. Both of those basically sold out in the preview. I guess technically we got to show one of them for, 30 seconds a few minutes ago. And now I'm down to the black and black, and it is almost sold out. The regular price is $230 here at ShopNBC. You guys are going to be able to pick this up at $99.82. And there's also four interest-free payments on top of that, B90475. So do take advantage of that. Larry, as always, man, thanks.
Hey, Tim, it's a pleasure.
Thank
great
you so
job,
much for
Tim.
Being here. And tonight, 8 p.m. Eastern, Jim Skelton's going to be out here with the Torbjörn. I know you're coming back for that. And you guys can join me on the 19th looking ahead, because that's the debut of Exoskeleton here at ShopNBC. And there's going to be some updates about that over on Facebook. So please join me on Facebook, Tim Temple, and I'll fill you in on what's happening as we continue to expand the watch program here at ShopNBC. Sense of weight loss starts in just 2 minutes, so stick around.